What's going on, folks? TJ Lowerman, a.k.a. That Sports Gamer here, and we are back, coming at you live with episode 29 of Bullpen Banter. Man, we are getting up there in these episode numbers. As always, we are streaming live on twitch.tv/thatsportsgamer and also gaming.youtube.com/thatsportsgamer. Hit the follow, hit the sub button to those places. I would appreciate that a lot. As you can see, we started off a little bit differently. I'm playing a little Battle Royale tonight. That's going to be the topic of the evening, Battle Royale Revisited. But before we get any further, let me tell you about who is joining me tonight. Currently, I have one Chris with me, and that is Snaggle J in the house.
The one that matters.
That's what they call him sometimes. I mean, I have not called him that. I am a number one supporter of Millennium OS. Hashtag full team mill. I don't know. But Millennium will be joining us in a few minutes. He is currently wrapping up his stream. Guys, can I tell you about how Miguel Sano is so good?
He's pretty good.
He is pretty nasty. So tonight we're going to be talking about Battle Royale a little bit. Mainly because some hot new cards dropped this week. Four rookies. I believe it's Chris Coughlin and three other guys I can't think of the names of. Chris Coughlin, JD Martinez, Clay Buchholz, and Chris Bryant. Let me pull up the old the D leagues for you guys watching at home. If you're not using daddyleagues.com, you are playing your sports games incorrectly.
Agreed.
So here we got these. There we go. Chris Bryant, Chris Coughlin, Clay Buchholz. That's a lot of C's right there. And then JD Martinez. Well, technically, Chris has a K. You also have a K in your Chris?
Yep.
Millennium, I don't believe, has a K in his Chris.
Nope.
How do we want to start this? Want to go worst to first?
Well, yeah, we could do that, I guess. Well,
I don't want to say worst. I don't want to say worst.
Worst to first, or you could do the mission order, whichever you prefer.
Ooh, that's worst to first, I think.
Nope, I think Buchholz is first.
Yeah.
In the missions.
Right. Oh, I'm sorry. JD Martinez. Okay. Yeah, sure. We'll talk about it in mission order. So there's four rookie guys. Collect them all, and then you can earn your way up to a Chris Bryant Live Series card, which some would say is the best third baseman in the game.
Some would say that, yes.
I mean, I'm willing to say he's my favorite third baseman in the game.
That's true. He's not my favorite third baseman in the game. But where could we possibly like talk about our favorites?
Speaking of voting on our favorites, we're going to be doing the Bullpen Banter Awards coming up here in a couple of weeks. We currently have nominations open. If you go to the link in the chat, and if you're watching this on an archive later, we will have the link in the show description. You can go and vote on who your favorite players are by position, by primary position, please.
Yes.
And this doesn't have to necessarily be the best player, just your favorite. Once we get all the nominations in, we'll then do a Twitter poll with the top four at each position and find us out who our favorites are. I believe the categories right now are favorites by position, favorite flashback, rated 90 or above, favorite flashback rated 89 or below.
Yep.
Favorite bunt cheeser.
Favorite bunt cheeser, yeah. Oh, that's been a hotly contested category so far. Yeah. Favorite legend card. Mm. Favorite utility player as well.
Oh, favorite utility player. I think for that you have to have at least three secondary positions.
Yeah, yeah. Four total position eligibility, your main position, and three extras.
Yeah, and when you vote, you must use the Daddy Leagues link to avoid confusion and keep it easy for everybody.
Yes, it has been very helpful thus far.
Yeah, but we'll continue to discuss that as the show goes on.
Yep.
Just to keep reminding you guys. So let's first take a look at this Clay Buchholz, rookie flashback. I need you to talk. How about you lead us through this while I'm, because I'm in the middle of this game. Just hit a double with Anthony Rizzo, so get ready, guys. We're going to win this.
So as we were talking about before the show, you guys will notice one common theme with all of these cards that are available this week is that they're all very good Battle Royale cards. That's not something we've said a lot with the cards that have been released lately. You know, a lot of people were kind of sour, saying, well, you know, why are we getting 270 overall bronze cards this late in the season? But you know what? There's still a lot of people who are playing BR, and this Clay Buchholz as a bronze is going to be a starter on a lot of people's BR teams. Again, you know, at 76 overall, he's not going to light the world on fire. But you've got clutch hits per nine and K per nine all over 60. He's got that good fastball. He's got the slider and the 12 to 6 change, which a lot of people like to use as a combination. Absolutely. And he's got a good speed difference, 14 mile an hour difference between his fastball and his changeup. So you know what? In short bursts in BR, this is going to be a guy you're going to want. And I mean, if you just happen to be starting out in Diamond Dynasty, playing head-to-head games in December, A, where have you been all season? And B, this would be a good card to have in your initial team. You know, he's not going to be a guy that like TJ is going to have or that I'm going to have at this point of the season in our regular everyday lineups. But for the newbie out there, he'd probably do exactly what you want.
Yeah, I've actually seen a lot of people playing Battle Royale now on based off my tweets that I've seen. I feel like a lot of people are playing it a lot more now than they were earlier in the year. Not really sure why that is, but I mean, it's a fun mode. I don't knock it, but I guess there's a lot of, I think a lot of people are trying to get those really super high rated cards right now.
Well, and that's the thing, and I know we're going to talk a bit more about it later, but yeah, there are a lot of quote unquote end game cards that you can only get in BR, mm-hmm. and you know. People got to chance it. I think a lot of people have geared towards BR since they made the changes to the reward tiers as well.
Yeah, that was definitely a big thing. It used to be 20 was the high one, right? And then they it's still 20, but I think the big reward was 20, but now hasn't that reward been moved down to like 12 or 16 or something like that?
Yeah, well, I thought it only went to 12 before.
No, definitely 20. Right? Definitely
20. Yeah, well, that's.
It's definitely 20. Because I know Jivo just did it, and pretty sure it was 20. I feel like I've never gotten that high. I usually get to, like, 10, if I'm lucky. Yeah. But yeah, I think a lot of those high-end cards, I mean, you can go out and try to grind all those coins and try to get that. But I feel like a lot of people are seeing it just being a lot easier to just go through Battle Royale and try to get it that way.
Well, and that's the thing. And I mean, it's the one thing I've cautioned people about with BR is playing BR is not going to make you a better Diamond Dynasty player.
It's a completely different game of
baseball. Yeah, it's basically, I equate it to like a baseball mini game. Mm-hmm. You know, you get in there every game. If you're playing against someone who's played a lot of BR, every game is the same. Literally, before anybody throws a pitch, both guys have two arms going in the bullpen immediately. And that's based off of typical, prototypical BR strategy that people employ.
Here's my thing. I wonder if that's why I have not been good at BR this year, because I try to play it like a real game.
Whoa.
I assume that's why I'm not doing well. Done well historically.
I've probably over the course of the summer probably done 40 to 50 BR runs over a various period of time. I haven't done a whole lot of it lately. But yeah, you have to get out of the mindset of what you would do in a baseball game and literally only think about how do I win this game 1-0? How can I immediately score a run, shut the other guy down, and have this over with? Or get a couple runs and make a guy quit.
I actually almost wish I think part of it is the mindset is they start you off in the first inning. I kind of wish they would have started you off in the seventh inning, even though it makes really no difference. But I think the mindset would get you in the right spot.
Possibly.
Just because then you know it's like, okay, need the bullpen going.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, there's still a lot of people still trying to grind out get their starter to go seven or get the starter to go six. And what am I trying to say? Get their starter to go three.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, it's just that strategy typically does not work.
Especially because they get tired after like 16 pitches, if that.
Well, yeah, as for a starter, yeah, they get about that. I mean, yeah, you want to try to go easy on your bullpen because usually it's 5-6 pitches and all of a sudden your bullpen guy's tired. Yeah. And it's like, okay, well, I still got to get 6 outs, or I still got to get, you know, 6 or 7 outs here. And it's just, it's difficult. It's difficult to play BR having played so much head to head.
Yeah, I agree 1,000%.
Yes. JD Martinez.
Yeah, let's talk about the next guy, JD Martinez. One of my favorite gold cards in this game. I think he was the second gold card I purchased this season. I forget if it was him or Betts. They were 1 and 2.
Yep.
So I've been a huge fan of JD Martinez. This one continues the domination against lefties with 87 contact versus lefties, 84 power versus lefties.
Yep.
The right side, 49 contact, 41 power. Which is not bad. 51 plate vision, not bad. 56 discipline, 50 clutch. And not bad ratings. But his versus lefty numbers are great. And as a bronze that you'll get in a BR round, especially with a lot of people using lefties in Battle Royale, I think he's a prime candidate for a BR draft.
Yeah, if you see JD Martinez pop up on your screen in a bronze BR round, you are absolutely grabbing him for your team and then trying to find another bronze who you can platoon with him. JD Martinez gives you unbelievable hitting against lefties, and he gives you above average defensive stats, which can make a huge difference in a BR game. You know, that 70 arm strength is the difference between throwing a guy out at home and not throwing a guy out at home in BR. Because again, it's not like Diamond Dynasty where you can have your pick of whatever player you want if you have the coins. In BR, you're limited to what comes up. So if you can get a guy like JD Martinez, yeah, you're going to take him 10 out of 10 times, unless you already have 3 diamond card outfielders.
But even still, just to have him coming off the bench would probably be worth it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because he doesn't have something that really hurts him. Like, even the 51 vision, that's not bad. It's not like it's not like you're rolling a guy off the bench that has 12 vision, which could sometimes be a problem.
Yeah, absolutely.
See, like, I'm already starting to start thinking I don't know. Continue. I don't know if we want to talk about Battle Royale separately, or if we just want to mix it into here. I want to talk about it separately. But here's something that I'm kind of thinking about. As you said, people get into games and they just start warming up guys immediately, right?
Yeah.
You're forced to use your starter one batter.
Yes.
You have JD Martinez on your team. They have a lefty starter. I would almost say bat JD Martinez leadoff.
Absolutely.
Force him to have that lefty matchup.
Yeah. Yeah. My strategy all along for BR, again, I put my best hitter in the one spot. Mm-hmm. And again, that's matchup dependent. You know, when you go into a BR game, if you're facing a righty or a lefty, you put the best chance to hit a home run in the leadoff spot. Because again, you get up on a guy 1-0, and then it becomes a scramble on their part because they have limited outs to get that run back.
Yeah.
And I've seen a lot of people, and I mean, you know, not hundreds, but I've had it happen more than a handful of times where you'll hit a home run in the top of the first inning in the first couple batters and your opponent will quit because they can quit and get out. And if it's their second loss, they could jump right back into another BR and get another draft going, and that's it. But yeah, I don't disagree with you. It's a perfectly acceptable strategy to try and hit a home run with your leadoff hitter in Battle Royale.
Yeah. And if not a home run, just get a double, then you can drive him in. But
yeah, that works too.
But definitely try to get that first guy on base, doing something, which would be huge.
Yep, absolutely. That's massive in BR.
Oh, my thing didn't update. Hold on. You may continue. Who's next?
Chris Coughlin.
Chris Coughlin. Did you know that at one point, Chris Coughlin played the most consecutive games for the Cubs? He was like the active leader in consecutive games played.
I did not know that.
I think they traded him, and that's what ended the streak. Could be wrong.
So, well, maybe. My first major disappointment with this card is that he does not have second base eligibility as the regular Chris Coughlin card does. So that's kind of a bummer. He only qualifies at the three outfield positions. Again, utility players in BR can be very helpful. But that contact, though, 87 versus righties, 83 versus lefties with 82 vision. He's pretty good on the defensive end. Again, as a silver player, probably a very desirable guy to have if he comes up in a round.
Yeah, the contact numbers are great. Also, he might even be the guy that you you could try to platoon JD Martinez with.
Absolutely. Yeah.
That would probably work. Apparently, yeah. Werdens, who I am playing right now, who you can't see because I'm on a different screen, is in the chat.
Well, then make sure that you give him a big tune-in.
Yeah, I'm going to try to do that.
Yeah. Coughlin would be a guy I would keep around as a pinch hitter for your pitcher as well. You know, again, if you're not using them. But, yeah, platoon with JD Martinez. I hit my pitcher sixth in BR.
I like that.
Because chances are you're probably not going to get – I mean, if you get to the sixth spot in the first inning, you're already feeling good about, you know, where your team is at. You'll probably have a couple runs on the board. If you get to the sixth in the second inning, you're already either into the bullpen or strongly considering going to the bullpen. So, yeah, I use that opportunity to get somebody – off the bench who is like a Chris Coughlin, somebody who can get on base if you really need it. So yeah, I hit my pitcher sixth.
All right. Like I might use that if I catch this L from Wardens.
Red Sox. What's up, man?
What's going on, Red Sox? Jared Chambers in the YouTube chat wants to know our thoughts on Fowler to the Cardinals.
Well, as a Blue Jays fan, I was hurt, but I'm glad they didn't pay him what the Cardinals are paying him. I liked Fowler. I think he's going to be a good outfielder for them. I'm a little worried. 16 plus million seems like a bit of a stretch, maybe. I don't remember Dexter Fowler being that good. He's worth $82.5 million, apparently. But yeah, no, I think it's a all around good move. It gives the Cardinals another dynamic bat. In a lineup that can seem quite boring from time to time. And it takes him from the Cubs and goes to the Cardinals, which is kind of a, you know, sticking it to them a little bit.
The old reverse Hayward?
Yeah, the old reverse Hayward. But yeah, no, I think it's a good move for the Cardinals. And I think it's a good Fowler as well.
Yeah, I think they're going to be a good team to use next year in a franchise mode, if that's how you play.
Yep. Don't disagree with that.
It's a good pickup for him. Gives him a solid outfield. I can't think of anybody who else they have in their outfield right now.
Piscotty?
Who we love Piscotty? Yeah.
Yeah, because Piscotty's going to play the outfield full-time because Carpenter's moving to first base.
And Holiday's gone. Right?
Holiday's gone. Yeah, he's with the Yankees.
Well, I cannot stop this guy right now.
Uh-oh.
B-dub, B-dub, B-dub. I think he's got like four zip lead on me.
Nice.
Word to the wise. Don't try to do
way
a show.
To go, way to go, B-dubs.
Don't try to do a show while playing games online.
Yeah, that's probably not smart.
Nobody's ever been successful at that, based on what I've seen on Twitch. Okay. Nobody's ever been able to play a game and talk at the same time.
Fair enough. Speaking of people who can't game and talk at the same time, I believe the third member of the wonderful team is in the building.
I believe that's referred to as a segue, guys. It's kind of professional. What's going on?
Chris, and Chris, what are your thoughts on Chris Coughlin?
I like Chris Coughlin a lot. I think he's a good, in terms of Diamond Dynasty, I think he is a good guy you can have on your bench for a budget team. Hits, again, like a lot of guys you see on budget teams, hits very specifically for you. Has a little bit of speed, a little bit of defense, but I think he plays well.
What do you love about the 82 plate vision?
Everything. What do I love about the what?
82 plate vision.
Love the 82 plate vision. You know I love the 82 plate vision. Anything you can get an extra 5 or 6 pitches out of a bat from by using your contact swing, I'm all about.
I'm all about you showing up. You know what that? Also, so you know what we've been talking about? since you were doing your own thing for a little bit. These cards are really good for Battle Royale. Thoughts? All these new cards?
Yeah, absolutely. When you're looking at Battle Royale, you're looking at guys in the draft. Play vision's a huge thing I like to look at for BR because, again, when you have pitchers that have their stamina ratings juiced up, you know, the stamina goes down much faster. That's absolutely something you want to keep an eye on, or maybe you can get through those bullpen arms faster as well.
Also, do you have any thoughts on Clay Buchholz or J.D. Martinez's new cards?
Do not like Clay Buchholz's new card. Anything with J.D. Martinez is great.
All right, just making sure we're all in agreement, though we kind of don't hate Clay Buchholz.
No.
Okay for BR.
Yeah, probably BR-centric, okay, he's pretty good.
I can see that.
Or have you been living under a rock for the last 7 months and you literally just started Diamond Dynasty today?
Yep.
Yeah, but you guys, also the argument we've always had, TJ, and I'm guessing Chris is on the other side of that too, is I'm not a big believer in long relievers. So Buchholz for a long time this year was a good long reliever.
The new Buchholz.
I know the new Buchholz. Oh, no, I understand the new Buchholz is a starting pitcher. I get that. But what I'm saying is the older Buchholz we have a problem with, and I don't think he's that much. Is the new Buchholz that much upgraded from the old one?
Listen, you're asking a lot of questions that I don't have answers to right now.
No, he's actually.
I know he lost a pitch.
I would say even playing. I mean, other than the fact that he's a starting pitcher and not a relief pitcher, really, he's basically a very similar card. A little bit more velocity on the fastball. On the flashback card has a 93, so I mean, he could probably touch 95.
Right.
If you get him in a full stamina kind of situation. But yeah, I think we're all probably in agreement here that all four of these cards are very BR-centric cards. And that's something we haven't really seen in the last month or so of new cards. It seems like these four cards were built specifically for Battle Royale drafts.
I do like the curveball. The 80 control in the curveball being 77 miles an hour. I don't know how I feel about the curve and the change being around the same speed. I'd like to see the curve maybe drop 5 miles an hour off the change.
Yeah.
But I do like the, you know, we always talk about the three-tiered speed, the 93 mile an hour fastball, 85 mile an hour slider. But I'm not a fan of that 48, even though the control's high on the curveball. The control's very mediocre for not only his pitches, but the BB over 9 as well.
Don't disagree with any of what you just said.
And when you're talking about Battle Royale, I mean, you're really talking, I mean, I think most people at this point, most of the higher level players look for a beefy bullpen and just to try to get through the first inning with your starter. I don't think anyone's looking for, especially not a 76 overall Clay Buchholz.
No.
How long with a good bullpen are you really going to leave a 76 overall Clay Buchholz in the game?
Yeah, I mean, if he pops up in a common round, or a bronze round, That's the situation where, you know, if you get a four pitcher bronze round and he might be the best guy and then you could go with him, then that's great. But yeah, again, the same thing with the Coughlin card, you know, as a silver, there's probably 50 guys you'd rather have, but there's going to be that one draft where Chris Coughlin's the best guy on the board and you're going to take him because of those 80 contact against lefties and righties. It's just what it is.
Yep.
Where are we? What do we got? Still got the Chris Bryant to look at, don't we?
Yes, we are up to the KB.
Chris Bryant, rookie flashback, 87 overall.
Of course, righty masher. Excellent.
So yeah, this Chris Bryant is a righty, 74 contact, 81 power against righties. He does have 78 power against lefties, with only 52 contact. The 26 plate vision is a big red X for me.
I did not see that earlier. That's a problem.
That is a huge, huge red X for me. Again, qualifies at third and all three of the outfield positions. Slightly above average fielding stats, slightly above average speed. Honestly, I don't see in BR or Diamond Dynasty, other than completing these missions, any reason why you would use this Chris Bryant card.
Yeah, I think go ahead, TJ.
No, yeah, that 25 plate vision pretty much seals the deal for me right there. I wouldn't see myself using this at all.
I could see if it came through. I mean, the problem is it's going to come through in a gold round if you're playing Battle Royale, and there are better gold cards out there. Even as a pinch hitter, I think we all agree the 26 plate vision takes it completely out as an at bat. He would have to bring something else to the plate for you. I mean, he's got decent speed in stealing, but it's not the kind you're going to put in late in a game.
Yeah, is what's it like? Stanton's like 25 plate vision.
Stanton's 25.
Yep. Yeah, and I don't really like using that, even though he's got like superpower.
Yeah.
So I can't see Chris Bryant as something I would really want to use.
Yeah, and I agree with Mills. I mean, again, you're going to get that one round where he's probably the best guy on there in a BR. In a straight head-to-head, I mean, if you just go right now and you look, he's going for just about 5,000 stubs if you put an order in. You could get the 93 flashback Ryan Zimmerman for about 500 stubs less, and he is probably twice as good as Chris Bryant and qualifies at third and in left field. So, again, in a head-to-head environment, you know, just do your homework. There are better cards available. If you get stuck with him in a BR, hope you're facing a righty. And, you know, he might pop one for you. He's got the ability to do so.
Excellent. Excellent points.
That's why we're here.
Yeah, there's a great question asked in the chat. I just lost my game. Which, did I lose it to BWWWWWW because he's better than me, or on purpose because now we get to do a Battle Royale draft together?
Oh, my.
So that's good. But we have a question in the chat from Gaming Freaks. He says, why am I so bad at Battle Royale, and yet I'm a high World Series DD player, but still can't succeed in BR? No explanation for that. I know the timing is different, but being realistic, come on, it's on all-star difficulty. Can you give me advice in this strange matter? We said it a little bit earlier ago. Battle Royale is not baseball. It is a much different beast.
It's like a mini game.
Yeah. Millennium, you weren't here when I mentioned it, but I said I think next year for Battle Royale, they should start you in the seventh inning just to get you in the proper frame of mind as to how the game's going. Because it's not really – I mean, it is the first inning of the game, but really it's the seventh inning of the game. And you need to think about getting your starter out quick and getting straight to your bullpen to get stuff done.
I actually agree with that. I mean, it's again, it's a mindset thing. It will not change anything else. But what I can tell Gaming Freaks is the problem that I had, and I think the problem that a lot of baseball purists have with the mode. When you go into Battle Royale, your first idea in your head is to treat it like a baseball game, where you're going to take some pitches, you're going to try to get the feel for the starter. And remember, in a regular baseball game, you're going to see the starter a lot. Like, even though let's talk not from a real baseball standpoint where everybody sees him three times. You're going to see the starter for probably somewhere around 18 to 20 outs. Whereas you're not going to see the same pitcher in BR for more than maybe five, six batters. So you have to know you have to jump on stuff a lot earlier. You have to understand the pitches that are coming to you. You have to realize that you're going to get, think about it like an all-star game. You're going to get every pitcher's best stuff the entire time. So you have to be prepared for that and prepare to jump on mistakes a lot faster than you would with like a regular game.
Round one of this Battle Royale draft, we got Prime Cargo, Prime Teixeira, Yogi Berra, and Prime CC Sabathia. So let me just kind of go over what I'm thinking now. What is it? We get a diamond and two golds and some silvers. I think my new plan of attack is I want like a three-headed monster bullpen and literally not care about anything else pitching-wise. Does stamina for relievers count in this or no?
You wouldn't notice a difference because they all start with their stamina so decreased that, I mean, if you had, for example, like, unless you had a long reliever, well, you would notice it. But if you had Andrew Miller versus a guy with 20 stamina, you might get two additional pitches out of it.
Yeah. So I think I'm going to go Cargo in this first round. Thoughts?
Cargo, and it's not a discussion as far as I'm concerned. Okay.
I agree. Cargo's the best
player on that board by far.
And he gives you the option to play all three outfield positions rather than a Teixeira. That only gives you first. Next up, we got Carlos Correa, Flashback Pedroia, Flashback Santana, or Jacob DeGrom. I kind of want to go. I kind of want to go Pedroia because I haven't used him.
The Pedroia is a good.
I feel like that might be a, trick right there. They might be trying to trick me with that.
The Pedroia is a good card, but I think the Correa is probably better. The Correa has the ability to play defense at shortstop, which is something you may miss later in the game. I think we talked about that before. Defense at shortstop specifically is very important. And also third base to prevent the bunt cheddar.
Never heard of that. What's that? What's bunt cheese? What I gain in contact with Pedroia, I lose in power.
Did somebody mention bunt cheese?
Yes.
You know, this is probably a good time to plug that there's a spot where you can vote for your favorite bunt cheeser of 2016.
Millennium, I love you, but I'm going to take Pedroia, mainly because I haven't used him yet.
That's what Battle Royale is about, though. Yeah, I love that.
Also, my thought is I might lead off Pedroia, hit cargo 2. Try to get that. Get him on, get him in. Take an early lead. Kind of my thought on this. Yeah, I think I'm going to try to use Snaggle J's technique, maybe about the pitcher 6th. Because I'm going to pinch it for him anyway by that time.
Yeah.
But yeah, don't forget you can nominate your favorite cards, including your favorite bunt cheeser, in the link in the chat. Let's see, we got Matt Dominguez, Carlos Ruiz, Josh Fields, and Bronson Arroyo. I feel like this might be a hot Bronson Arroyo spot. Sinker, slider, change, 12-6, and a fastball. Just keep him off balance for like two or three batters, and get him out.
Yeah. I'm a fan of the Ruiz card too, but I think you're right. I think you don't want to waste bronzes on guys you might get upgrades for later. That Josh Fields card, by the way, is pretty good too.
There's gas too, right?
Yeah, there's gas. I was gonna say that Josh Fields card is sleepy, really good.
I think for the awards, we're gonna have voting open for 2 weeks. Then we'll have the top 4 nominations of each, and then we'll do a final vote of those cards. And then we'll reveal the nominations on the show on the 26th of December, if I have my dates correct. And then the 2nd is when we'll have the winners. That math checks.
Sure does. I'm on Josh Fields here, by the way. I agree with Mills. That Josh Fields card out of 77, that's a disservice to how good that card actually is.
All right, well, too bad. I took Arroyo.
Well,
hey, good man. For you then. Agree to disagree.
Hey, it's your draft. Walk a tour.
All right, we got Tim Beckham, the shortstop, Brett Wallace, the third baseman, Trevor Cahill, the relief pitcher, and Christian Friedrich, the lefty starter. Brett Wallace is that superpower at third base. Can play both corner positions. Beckham can play short, first, and second. 50s contact and power. Cahill's nothing to write home about. Got a sinker and a slider.
I'm partial to the Friedrich card, the Christian Friedrich. Low hits over 9, but being a lefty, and I like his pitch mix a little bit. So I would actually say if you're going to fill out the starters with bronzes, I don't think he's a bad one to go with, especially, again, with a lefty. A lot of people are still stacking lineups against righties. So,
yeah, and even if I just use him for, like, again, like 2 to 3 batters and we have a 3-headed monster bullpen.
Right.
I don't think that's a bad call.
Yeah, no. I like Friedrich here. The other three guys are guys that hopefully they end up being bench guys at best. So yeah, you're better off taking Friedrich here. He can get you through an inning, and that's probably what you'll want.
All right, then we got Paolo Orlando, Abraham Almonte, Chase Headley, and Henry Owens. I almost kind of want to lead towards either Paolo Orlando because he's got some good contact numbers. He's got some speed. Almonte also has the speed, doesn't have the contact numbers. He's actually also a little slower than Orlando, so between the two of them, I would probably take Orlando. Chase Headley, kind of trash. And then Henry Owens is also essentially the same as the Christian Friedrich pick. 4-seam change, slow curve, and slider. Nothing really terrible about him. 47 velocity, but...
Yeah, I would say Orlando or Owens here, just depending on your personal preference.
I also think Orlando is a good pick because he gives you some contact off the bench, and I think he gives you some speed off the bench too. Yeah. I like Henry Owens. I think he's a decent pick. Again, doing the bronze starting rotation, but Orlando settles your speed role for late rounds if you need it.
And again, like the cargo, he can play all three outfield positions. So if we get a monster corner outfielder, we still have the ability to move one of them to another spot. Speaking of monster corner outfielders, we have rookie flashback Carlos Beltran, flashback Victor Martinez, Jacquin Benoit, and Rich Hill. See, here's the problem. I kind of want Benoit to kick off this three-headed monster, but then that means we miss out on a Carlos Beltran or a Victor Martinez.
That Benoit card's a monster. That Benoit card is an absolute beast from your bullpen. And if you are going to use your bullpen as your main pitching, you have to have that Benoit card.
I think that's what we got to do. Here's the thing. This is where I would have this idea for the three-headed monster, and I would pick Victor Martinez, probably pick Carlos Beltran. So I think this is what we have to do now is we have to focus on this game plan and make this Benoit pick.
Yeah, if it was me, the V-Mart is hard to pass up because it's hard to say what might pop out for a catcher for the rest of the draft.
That's a prime position right there.
Yeah.
But your main problem is...
And it's a prime card at a prime position as
and
well.
He's super slow. That's the only problem. If he gets on base, you're screwed.
And that's the thing. And his defensive ratings are not that great as well. Right. So the reason why I think you go Benoit is because, again, in BR, you need a guy behind the plate who can throw people out. Sure, you might end up with Robinson Chirinos back there, but he gives you a better opportunity to throw guys out than this Gold V-Mark card does.
Yeah. But this Carlos
Beltran. That's what a BR game can come down to.
This Carlos Beltran is kind of a monster. 82 contact versus righties, 88 power versus lefties, which is a little weird. But it gives you like a reason to use him for righties or lefties, plus 90 speed, 82 fielding. But no, we got to go with this Benoit. Also, Rich Hill, not a bad card, but I don't think, is anybody using gold starters?
The only reason you use a gold starter is if you're going to stack your starting rotation, because you can't guarantee you're going to get it.
And even if you stack your starting rotation, you're probably going to have at least two silvers in it, right? So,
yeah,
because you get one diamond and two gold, so
yeah.
Who knows? All right, we have Daniel Fields, the center fielder, Billy Butler, Jake Smith, who doesn't have a picture, and Asher Wojciechowski, which I'm going to guess. I feel like Billy Butler, we might take him, and he might be a bench player. But again, like V-Mart, no speed. What's the speed? 14. That's atrocious.
These cards are all so bad, but I would take Butler just for the simple fact that you'd be getting a bronze card in a common round. So, true. So you know, he gives you, again, he's got pretty good contact ratings from both sides. Again, the other cards are just so, I mean, you wouldn't even want to risk having Asher Wojciechowski out there for one batter.
Yeah.
As a starter. You know, Smith would be, you know, at best your seventh arm in the bullpen. Mm-hmm. I don't know what you do with Field. At least Butler could be a productive card.
Yeah, he could come off the bench to get a little pinch hit for me. Or at the very worst, he's got 73 vision. He could grind out a pitcher and just wear him out for me.
Yeah.
Daniel Fields doesn't have the speed to really be your speed guy off the bench. Only 70 speed, but.
Let me devil's advocate one thing here. When you have a common round and you don't want to waste that bench spot because you might get a better bench player than Billy Butler, you take that Smith card, you put him on your bullpen, and you never touch him. Yeah, because you're not going to have to worry about stamina. Stamina resets.
Right.
So that's whenever I get my common round, unless I get like a jewel bronze, I'm looking at that common card as one of my relievers that I'm never going to use.
I just feel like Billy Butler could be helpful.
You'll say that, but then, like I said, but you're not going to have to worry about common round cards. You're going to get a better card than Billy Butler in these rounds.
Well, here's the problem. Will I get two? Because I still don't have a first baseman. Granted, I don't think Billy Butler would be my starting first baseman, but.
Right, but when you put him on the bench, you're just looking for a bench bat. It doesn't matter what position he plays.
Mm. All right, I'm gonna take your advice. We're gonna go. Jake Smith. Dude doesn't even have a picture. All right, so
he's a monster. And he's a free agent too.
We got Drew Stubbs, Luis Valbuena, Zach McAllister, and Hector Santiago. Santiago would be a not a bad starting pitcher selection. Sinker, change, four seam, cut, curve. Some decent numbers. Zach McAllister in the pen would be all right, I guess. Valbuena is a silver in a bronze round. Good power versus righty. Drew Stubbs is a little bit of everything. Got a good arm, got some good speed, can play some defense well. A little contact versus lefties. It's kind of a toss up right here.
You know why that's
good.
Good. Now you know why that's a 77 card, right? That Hector Santiago.
Why is that?
Look at the home run over nine rating.
47.
Yeah, that's why it's a 77. That's a silver. That's a silver starting pitcher.
Yeah.
In a bronze round. Again, it just depends on what you want to do. I think Valbuena could be valuable. In terms of the fact that he has power and vision, low contact though, he can play all over the infield. Stubbs, good contact against lefties, but that Santiago card pitches like a silver.
All right, let's take the silver. And he's a lefty, which means they got to think.
Yeah.
I'll buy into
it. Not that I'd want you to take him, but little known fact about Zach McAllister, he is actually the cousin of Kevin McAllister, made famous by the Home Alone movies.
Just so that way, when you give up the home run by Zach McAllister, you can put your hands in your face and go, ah!
If we're playing in Yankee Stadium, I can be like, man, this guy's lost in New York.
Exactly.
God.
All right.
Little Christmas time humor on the show.
All right. We got David Freese, the third baseman, Mark Teixeira's live series card, the Coker, Phil Coke, and Jeff Hoffman, the starting pitcher. I feel like I want to avoid this Jeff Hoffman. I feel like this is a landmine. Throwing a 70 starting pitcher up there. That's not a lefty. So, do we go with the Coker to get a lefty arm in there, Teixeira to get a first baseman, or Freese to get a third baseman? Also, I've had a lot of luck with Freese. But I'm not sure here. I feel like Coke might be the play. But let me get some input.
Good, Chris. I have a couple ideas, but we'll hear this.
Yeah, that Hoffman card, I have a love-hate relationship with the Hoffman card. Again, you know, he would fill out a spot in your rotation, but he's very underwhelming, and I wish he had another breaking pitch other than the curveball. At this point, given where the team is at, I would probably take Phil Koch for the simple fact that he's left-handed. I hate that Mark Teixeira card, and I hate the David Freese card, so I wouldn't even consider them, but that's my personal opinion and not necessarily fact.
I agree. You have eight silvers left at this point. Your starting rotation is almost filled. I think Phil Koch is the pick. You get that another spot out of that bullpen. You still have five bullpen arms. Sorry, full bullpen arms besides that to pick up.
And he could be effective.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, he's got a good K over nine number.
He's not a little boosted on the.
Yeah, a little boosted on the home run over nine, but, I mean, good velocity. He's got a weird – not a weird, weird windup, but enough to where it's hidden. The ball's hidden long enough.
Yeah. Yeah, that Coke is – you know what? When you get into that one game where you're 8-0 and it's the sixth inning and you need to get a lefty out and you remember, man, I have Phil Coke down there, that's when you're glad you take him.
Well, I mean, if it's sixth inning, we got bigger problems to deal with. All right, we got Grady Sizemore, center fielder, catcher Sandy Leone, Tyler Duffy, the relief pitcher, and Drew Hutchinson, the starter. I almost feel like we might pick the Sandy Leone just for defensive purposes. 78 fielding, 76 arm strength. I mean, who knows what we're going to get? Well, we still need have a lot of silvers to get through, but.
I like the Hutch card for the rotation. Again, I think that's I don't like his hits over nine, but his other ratings are pretty good. Circle change is always a beast pitch against other users, because not only do you get the change up, but it actually drifts on people too. You can throw it outside to righties. So I mean outside to lefties as an out pitch.
Yep.
So
and he's got the slider and the circle change, so they both kind of break opposite each other. So you can keep guys thinking on that one.
Right.
All right, yeah. I shall be talking to this Drew Hutchinson.
Yeah, and again, I would be on the Hutchinson card here because
he's a Blue Jay. Was a Blue Jay.
Well, yeah, but that's the thing is familiarity. I'm familiar with his windup. I'm familiar with his meter. You know, it's just one of those things where if you got to get through an inning with him, at least you're familiar with a guy. You know how fast his meter is. You've used him multiple times.
You're really going to love this round. We got Kevin Pillar in center.
I see it.
Russell Martin behind the plate. Pedro Baez to close or Adam Wainwright to start. I feel like it's kind of good that we didn't take Sandy Leon. We can go get Russell Martin here, but we could also get Pillar here. Pillar can cover some ground in the outfield, which would be nice for our center field spot that we have open. He's got some contact, got some vision. Russell Martin could be our man behind the plate. Pedro Baez could be the second head of our three-headed monster, possibly. Not sure.
I'm going to throw everybody for a swerve here because everyone's going to expect me to say Pillar or Martin. I would take Pedro Baez because he has... For a 79, he has some really, really nice ratings. He has upper tier velocity. You still have quite a few silvers and, you know, left. So Russell Martin, he gives you the defense, but his hitting is just not very good. Pillar is a nice card, but again, with so many rounds left, and the fact that you have Cargo, who you can move around to the different outfield positions, there is a very good possibility that you will get another outfielder better than Pillar. And the Wainwright at this point, that would just be a wasted pick as far as I'm concerned.
Agreed.
I don't think that's a swerve. I think that's the right pick. When you talk about playing against other users, velocity is king.
Yeah.
You got to be able to throw off of your fastball against other users if you're not throwing knuckles. So... I mean, I love Pillar's defense. I love Martin's defense. And you know me, I've always preached up the middle, especially at catcher, to control a run game. But that Baez card, that high K over 9 shows itself with it when you pair it with that velocity.
All right. I'll take Baez. I can live with that decision. Now we have a 2.5-headed monster. Mm-hmm. Or 1.5-headed monster.
That Wainwright card, by the way, is overrated. He's got a pumped-up home run over 9, I think. Yeah. So.
We got the Alex Gordon. I guess this is a rookie flashback.
If it's primary, the third base, yeah.
Yeah. Then we got Evan Gattis. Live series card. And then a flashback, Vinny Pastano. Flashback, Cole Hamels. Which is the starting pitcher with 4 pitches. As opposed to his prime flashback that only had 3 pitches. What in the world are you doing to me with this pitch? Okay. I feel like Pastano could be effective. Not got the super gas, though. Gattis, I mean, we're still looking for a catcher. He's probably the best hitting catcher we're going to find here on out. Alex Gordon has an arm at third base and can hit righties. What are we thinking?
I think Gordon's out of this conversation. I love Gattis. I love Gattis's hitting. Are you going to and you know what? His arm's good, too. What I worry about with Evan Gattis is, let's see if I can bring it up real quick, because I know it doesn't show it on the card, which they need to fix next year. What you're going to have to worry about, because I know the way you pitch sometimes. Well, no, he's got a 72 blocking. Screw that. Gattis is the pick.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't disagree. If this was earlier in the draft, I would very seriously consider Vinny Pastano, because that slider of Pastano's is unbelievable. Again, he's very good out of the bullpen, and I've used him a lot this year. But yeah, at this point of the draft, you have to take Gattis. The fact that Gattis also qualifies in the outfield gives you a little bit of flexibility. If, you know, for some reason a gold catcher happens to show up in a round or two. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know,
we still have a center fielder. We could probably move a Cargo if we really needed to. But
I agree with Mills here. I think it's pretty clear that Gattis is the pick.
Pistano has 95 hits per nine, 97 Ks per nine. Just saying.
Yeah, I love that Pistano card, and he's got a weird windup too.
Side piece.
But like I said, that being said, I think we can do better at relief pitcher than him, especially when you're going to lean on them.
We're running out of spots, but let's take Evan Gattis. But
yeah,
all right, here we go. We got Cameron Maben live series, flashback Matt Carpenter with third and first base eligibility. Hunter Strickland coming out of the pen, and Alex Cobb. I feel like maybe we go Strickland. Here's my worry, is that we're going to have, like, a whole bunch of low 70, high 70, low 80 relievers. It's just a thought.
I like the Carpenter here. I know he's not much of a hitter against lefties.
Mm-hmm. The thing is,
you know what, there's no BR team that you could put together that way you're not going to have to platoon somebody. Again, first and third base eligibility gives you a little bit of flexibility if you get someone better in the upcoming rounds. But yeah, I think I like the Carpenter here. I think Strickland is kind of redundant with Pedro Baez. I know they're a little bit of a different pitch mix, but you know, Strickland gives you a couple extra miles an hour, but they're essentially the same pitcher.
I think they just swap out a slider for a curveball.
Yeah. So me personally, I think it's Carpenter is probably the best guy here.
I like the Carpenter, but that Hunter Strickland is a BR nightmare. When you bring him
throws
in.
Ched, right? So
yeah, he doesn't throw cheddar. I mean, he throws Gouda. He throws that kind of cheese that you go to the nice restaurants for.
I got some Swiss plate in the fridge.
That's what I'm saying. You get a little plate that's got, you know, some sausage, some you know, chorizo on it. That's the cheese that Hunter Strickland throws. And then you throw in that curveball behind it. Dude, I think Strickland – I mean, I agree we have to start getting some bats. I would actually pick Maben over Carpenter here, but I think Strickland's the pick.
So you're saying he's the kind of dude that, like, if you go to an all-you-can-eat, you see this, you go get the plastic, and you cover your pockets.
Hunter Strickland is the kind of guy you start putting in your bag and hiding, like, in your jacket pockets. So when you walk out, you have cheddar all day.
All right. Well, we got Hunter Strickland. Now our choices are Quinton Berry, Mark Reynolds, Brandon Gomes, who we only have two reliever spots left. I kind of don't want to waste them on 69 bronzes. Then we got Ivan Nova, who I don't think would be a bad fifth starter for us. Though this dude is rocking the red, white, and blue Baltimore jersey. So I kind of want to pick him. Also good contact numbers. Also, Mark Reynolds has mad power.
All of those things are true.
Brandon Gomes, I don't want to waste another bullpen spot.
And I don't think you can pick Ivan Nova, even though you're trying to. I mean, unless you pray that Ivan Nova doesn't get picked, he's that starter that'll hurt you. I don't really like Quinton Berry that much, but that might be the pick. What is Quinton Berry's speed again?
57.
Ugh. Yeah.
He doesn't do enough for you.
No. Yeah, I would hate to take the Ivan Nova card here, but he may have the most upside of the four cards that are on the screen. And that's sad, but I mean, the you know, Reynolds, yeah, you're hoping he hits one deep, but you know, the vision is just he's just a bad card.
Yeah, I agree. I don't think you can. Oh man,
do we get the Nova and be like, okay, he's got one batter, maybe two, then we're done.
Yeah, I mean that would probably work.
Oh yeah, absolutely. He's the guy that as soon as you go in and see Nova starting, you're into the bullpen and you have two guys going, and you immediately mound visit and you're ready to go.
All right, here we go. We got Denard Span, Eduardo Nunez, flashback Alan Craig, who might be a BR monster. And Ken Giles, who also throws cheddar. I feel Alan Craig's the pick. Gets us our first baseman. Tons of contact. Power versus lefties. So if they want to do that lefty start thing, he could be the sneaky lefty that if they pitch a lefty, we hit him leadoff. And we get that yak. We take that 1-0 lead, and we end this thing. Though, Denard Span, tons of contact versus righty, huge vision, great fielding, good speed. Eduardo Nunez, not bad. Can hit righties or lefties. Lots of vision. Ken Giles versus Chet. Four good picks. For where we are right now, I think we got four good picks right here. Can't go wrong. But I think Alan Craig is going the rightest. Chris?
Good, Chris.
That's the best thing to say, Chris.
I think Alan Craig, again, you know, the only thing that gives me pause is that first base in terms of is very deep in terms of guys that can hit. Mm-hmm. But Craig can play right field. Again, his fielding ratings are not that great, so he could be a liability depending on what stadium you're playing in. I agree with a couple of guys put in the chat. I think EJ said Giles gives you your bullpen's too righty heavy. And again, I love Ken Giles. I love that card, great velocity. But I think at this point, you look at the contact ratings and the power versus lefty, and the vision of that Alan Craig card, and you know, it's just like you have to. 35 speed gives you a little bit of pause, but you know what? At this point of the draft, beggars can't be choosers.
Hey, did you guys know that if you're in the middle of a draft, you can just hit back and you'll just come back into the same spot?
Yes.
Had no idea.
I agree. I don't think it's even a question that Alan Craig's the picker.
Yeah. While there are other guys, I mean, maybe we catch a gold in one of these silver rounds. But if we catch a gold, are we going to catch one with 87 contact versus righties, 93 contact versus lefties, and 84 power versus lefties? Questionable. The fielding kind of sucks, but what you going to do? Also, super worst case scenario, we do get a super first baseman. Again, we have guys that are currently in corner outfield spots that could both of them could either play center field if we wanted to do something weird there. All right, we got Cameron Maben back for a second time. Azdrubal Cabrera, we still need a shortstop. He can play shortstop and second. Then we got flashback Todd Frazier, who against lefty is a monster, decent against a righty. And the Rockies lefty, Jake McGee. So, I don't know. I'm thinking McGee's the play, gets us our lefty, gets us a good pitcher. Got a kind of a funky windup. Good Ks per nine, good stats.
I like the Frazier card a lot, but that McGee card is a great lefty. So, I think McGee's the pick. Again, I still like Cameron Maben, but I think if you want to guarantee yourself a good lefty, Jake McGee's the pick.
Mm-hmm. Agreed. Jake McGee's probably. Again, I like the Frazier card. I like the Maben card. You could probably even make a minor case for the Cabrera card. But at this point, again, big lefty, Jake McGee, funky windup, hard slider, good fastball. Probably everything the bullpen needs at this moment.
I will say one thing here. Remember this.
The Titans.
If you take this McGee card, you are going to be starting at least two bronzes in the field. So that's another thing as well.
Theoretically, yeah. Well, we have three picks. We have three silver round picks left after this.
You know, right. We'll pull that JD Martinez bronze. And...
That'd be huge. First off, we pull that JD Martinez. That'd be amazing. Let's take Jake McGee, though. That does shoot the idea down of getting three gold bullpen guys, but I think that's already dead. Again, I do like the Frazier. It's a ton of power against lefties. So that means we have to face lefties. So. Yeah. We'll see how that happens. All right, let's go Jake McGee. Boom skis. All right. We got Michael Bourne, Jimmy Rollins, Joseph Gallo, and Jaime Garcia. No, I want someone better as our last bullpen pick than Jaime Garcia. Thoughts? Though, five pitch mix, slider, fastball, slider, four seam, two seam, sinker, change.
And 91 stamina.
Need the stamina. Bourne's got good speed, good reaction, some okay contact. J-Roll's got a little bit of contact versus lefties, can play the field a bit. Gallo could be that off-the-bench guy that we didn't want out of Mark Reynolds that bats lefty. Thoughts, Chris with the K.
Man, this is tough. I mean, it's like Mills said last round. We're looking at the possibility of having to start two bronze cards.
But who's a bronze that could help us? Do we think Michael Bourne playing center field for us could be helpful? 86 fielding, 89 reaction, 73 speed. He can get on a ball.
And that's the thing. You know, Bourne, you know, he's going to play above average center field. And also, again, you know, his contact ratings might not be that great, but obviously with the, you know, I think he's, what is that card of? 73 speed, his current card.
So we could slap again, him on, maybe beat it out.
He still has the ability to beat a ball out, you know, that other players might not. But again, the Jimmy Rollins, we've talked a few times during this draft about having fielding at shortstop.
72 arm strength, though. I kind of am terrified.
Yeah. I would have to say I probably would be leaning Michael Bourne.
I agree. I think I would probably go with Michael Bourne as well.
All right, let's do Michael Bourne.
Bunt cheese has been suggested in the chat.
You bunt cheese the Bourne?
Well, yeah, we're leading them off. Bourne lead off, Cargo right behind him.
I do like EJ. The one thing EJ said was you could lead off Gallo against lefties, against righties, and you would know he's at least going to get that good matchup.
Yeah. All right. Now, Ozzie Smith. I think we got our shortstop, Ozzie Smith. Not the prime flash, not the main legend. This is a older one. Jonathan Villar, though, also got contact and a little bit of power. Smith has the defense, so we're literally just giving up that spot in the batting order, unless we bunchies. Todd Frazier, live series, tons of power versus righties and lefties. Could be our third baseman. Or we go get our final bullpen spot with a Justin Wilson, 83. He also throws Chet, if I remember correctly.
Man, I would almost want you to get that Todd Frazier just for the power potential.
Mm-hmm. I'm not against it.
Not terrible.
Ozzie Smith is an out at the plate, essentially.
But not with contact swing. He has a very smooth swing.
At 91 speed, he could beat something out on the infield.
Right.
99 bunchies.
And unparalleled defense at shortstop.
Yeah, you're not getting a better shortstop right now. 99 fielding, 83 arm, 94 accuracy, 97 reaction. He's on balls.
The Smith, your worry with the Smith is he's not going to hit. You know, again, those ratings are just ungodly to look at on my screen. Mm-hmm. I do like the Frazier. Good power.
We just battle all day.
His vision. That vision is a game changer when it comes, like you said, to bat. Not only battling, but again, if you contact swing with him, he can get a lot of those flares. The flares that people say that MLB The Show is missing a lot of this year, the Texas leaguers, he gets a ton of them because of that.
Yeah. Jonathan Villar
also no slouch.
Yeah, I agree. I would say Smith. Smith is, and again, you're getting, you know, not that it for optics at least, you're getting a gold player in the silver round.
Also true.
So you can say that about him as well.
All right, let's do Ozzie Smith.
Plus those sideburns. Man.
All right, we got Ryan Healy, who apparently his parents didn't know how to spell the name Ryan correctly. Matt Dominguez, Charlie Villanueva, my favorite college basketball player, and Ryan the Butcher.
Ooh, that's a rough one.
Don't want to go Butcher in hopes that we get another bullpen guy. Don't want to go Charlie Villanueva in case we get another bullpen guy. Matt Dominguez, Ryan Healy, not terrible. Healy and Dominguez, pretty much the same, but Healy's got better contact and power versus lefties. Based on this picture, I almost want to call him Fat Dominguez. Ooh. As someone who's fat, I'm allowed to call him that. 6'2", 220? Jesus, this is a bad picture.
Man, I don't know. I think you have to go Healy here. I agree with the Healy pick.
Ryan Healy?
Yep, Ryan Healy.
Got him.
Yeah. Zero Healy.
Yeah, Healy would be my pick too.
All right, look at this quartet of bullpen arms. So we're stuck with one of these guys, which is kind of whack. Thanks MLB for your whackness. We have Matt Reynolds, Justin Miller, Derek Holland, and Jabba Chamberlain.
Oh man.
This really hurts our three-headed monster technique. Though we do have, I mean, we have four good relievers.
Yeah. Does the Derek Holland still have all five of Derek Holland's pitches?
Sinker, slider, change, knuckle curve, and four-seamer.
Yeah, that's pretty beastly out of the bullpen.
Yeah, I like that a lot.
He'll be our third lefty option.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, you know, again, that's a very unique combination coming out of the bullpen. Everything moves to a certain degree. Obviously, I like the Joba card because, man, his beard game in that card is...
Beard game is so strong.
Actually, yeah, Red Sox said that in chat, Movember Joba.
Yeah, that would qualify as one of the Movember NHL cards that they have.
Yeah.
The Joba card. But yeah, no, again, Holland is a unique bullpen. And in BR, where especially if you get up against somebody who's been playing it for a long time, a unique card in the bullpen will sometimes catch them by surprise.
All right. So now we're going for our bench or possibly new starters. We'll see. Might have a new starter here. We got that dude, Brandon Phillips, who we already have. Dustin Pedroia at second. Joe Mauer at first base, who we already have. Alan Craig. The Flying Hawaiian, Shane Victorino, who we have. Michael Bourne in center. I feel like the Flying Hawaiian, kind of the same, but better. And then we have Travis d'Arnaud. When we have Evan Gattis currently in our lineup. I feel like I like the Flying Hawaiian play. Speed, contact, fielding, arm, vision, a little bit of everything. But again, Bourne, kind of the same player. Victorino would be better against lefties. My fear of Joe Mauer, super slow. Tons of contact, not a ton of power. That dude, pretty good. But not going to play over Dustin Pedroia. Travis d'Arnaud, he's all right, but I feel like he might be, we might, this might be the point where you take Travis d'Arnaud to be your backup catcher after Gattis gets on with his super slow speed and you need to replace him. Give me your thoughts.
I think Victorino is the pick. I know what you're saying about taking him and hoping hoping you get something else.
True, but also if we take Victorino, Bourne becomes a speed guy off the bench, which is not a problem.
Right.
Yeah, I'm okay with Victorino. Again, I look at Mauer here as a possible guy who could get a hit off the bench, but you know the speed is kind of scary. Really, wouldn't use him for anything else.
And the power difference, the contact difference. I mean, versus lefties, Victorino's actually better.
Yeah.
But versus righties, Mauer's about 18 points.
Yeah, you can't discount the fact that Victorino is a switch hitter as well.
Yeah.
So he gives you a pretty good opportunity from either side of the plate. His defensive ratings are very good as well. Yeah, I agree. I think Victorino is definitely the pick.
All right, so we have the Hawaiian who flies. All right, now we got a quartet of more outfielders, which is exactly what this team needs. David Murphy, Ryan Rua, Domingo Santiago, and Lonnie Chisenhall.
I'm not sure who Domingo Santiago is, but I know there's a Domingo Santana on the screen.
It's his brother, same dude.
Brother from another mother.
Ryan Rua has corner outfield and corner infield positions. I don't think David Murphy really does anything for us except for vision. Santiago can ball against lefty. Chisenhall's got good contact, good vision, good power. Decent power, I guess. Chisenhall also gives us corner infield and corner outfield spots.
Yeah.
I like Ryan Rua here. I just like Ryan Rua being able to do a lot against a lot. Low contact versus righties, but I like that he does a lot for you, can play a bunch of different spots. I would take Santana if you need somebody to hit against lefties.
I don't think it's lefties.
Yeah, I think Rua is probably better than Chisenhall, I would think.
I know these contact numbers versus righties.
Yeah.
75 to 49 for the contact. And the power's not too far off.
I like the Rua card, but the thing is with Chisenhall, again, being able to play the outfield and the infield, and the fact that we have Ryan Healy as our third baseman currently, with Chisenhall, you have maybe a few more options. Again, I don't dislike the Ryan Rua card. I just like the Chisenhall card more. But again, that's me personally.
The chat says Chisenhall. I'm sorry, Millennium.
Go for Chisenhall.
We are go for Chisenhall. All right. We have Chris Owings. Is that Micah Owings' brother? I think so, right? Emilio Bonifacio and the ability to play every position known to man except for first and catcher. Matt Kemp and Nori Aoki. Nori Aoki, tons of vision, tons of contact versus lefties, decent contact versus righties.
I see Nori Aoki in my nightmares. That guy in franchise mode, no matter what team I am in franchise mode, that guy beats the hell out of me. I cannot get him out.
Bonifacio could be the pick. 85 speed and a ton of position eligibility. Though his fielding ratings aren't that great, so pretty much anywhere he plays is going to be a liability. Matt Kemp can really hit against lefties. But fielding and speed aren't really there. 58 fielding, 52 speed.
I like Bonifacio's reaction. That at least allows him to get to balls a little faster. Mm-hmm. Whether he catches them or not, you know, that's still remains to be seen.
Yeah.
I like his speed, but I think we have speed guys. I think Matt Kemp might be the pick here. Decent in terms of reaction. Okay speed. I actually think Kemp might be the pick because, again, I don't know how you hit lefties, though, so far. So far, I don't think we have a lot of lefty power.
We have...
Ooh, Alan Craig. Craig. Give me outside of that.
I feel like Gattis has lefty power as well. But Kemp coming off even just to be the pinch hitter for our pitcher would be good.
Yeah, I think Kemp is, you know, again, you know, you get into a late inning situation against Chapman, and you have Matt Kemp on the bench. Mm-hmm. Could be a...
You might feel confident. Advantage. Yeah.
No, not definitely not that, but...
Dude, you bringing Chapman against me? I'm confident. Aoki, I don't like his swing. Good player, don't like his swing.
Yeah.
We're taking Matt Kemp here. All right. Aaron Judge, Justin Arugiano, who essentially is the same as that Matt Kemp card. Domingo Santiago again, a.k.a. Domingo Santana. And then Jamail Weeks, related to Ricky, I believe so. I don't like any of these picks.
Rough. It's a rough looking round.
Yeah, I mean, maybe Aaron Judge for the defense. Maybe, but you have defense in the outfield already. 68 fielding, 52 speed. That's,
yeah.
Is it? What is Judge have the arm? Is that the guy that has the arm? Or is that Aaron Hicks? I'm gonna have that.
Hicks,
I'm gonna
has,
have
the, Hicks has the cannon.
Yeah,
Hicks has the arm.
I don't, dude. I
feel like Kemp just covered around. I feel like Kemp just covered all these positions. I feel like Jamail Weeks, just in case. Place the middle infield. We don't have a middle infielder on the bench.
What does Ruggiano look like? I mean, Ruggiano hits lefties, but again, plays only outfield. We got a bunch of outfielders already.
He's Matt Kemp, just not as good.
Yeah.
I feel like Jamail Weeks can play that, cover that middle infield spot in case something happens.
Yeah, in case somebody gets hurt.
I don't like him, but we're going to take him. Oh, look at this. Now we got something going on here.
Something cooking in the last round.
We got flashback Todd Frazier. Live series Jacoby Ellsbury, flashback Andre Ethier, or flashback Cliff Floyd.
Wow.
Is that the Cliff Floyd that everybody wins in Battle Royale?
Yeah, the 84.
Yeah.
Let's see. Ones that would start over our current starters, probably Todd Frazier will play third. Jacoby could be our starting center fielder. Fielding, reaction, speed, contact. Then we have two speed. Then we have Victorino and Bourne on the bench. Not a huge fan of Cliff Floyd's swing.
Yeah, I mean, if you don't like Cliff Floyd's swing, then that ends that conversation right there.
Huge fan of Andre Ethier. Don't know if I like his swing. He could start in the outfield. We could move Paolo Orlando around, or move Paolo Orlando to the bench.
I love that Ethier card because he can, again, the flashback version of Andre Ethier is very good against lefties. Yeah, his power against lefties is not great, but his contact against lefties is actually better than it is against righties. You know, again, you'd be, you know, is Paolo Orlando more valuable as a bench player? And then have Ethier in right field. Again, the Frazier card here too, I think is a upgrade over Healy. Is it a greater upgrade? Possibly. But yeah, the Floyd card, you're probably going to get one as your sixth game anyway. So.
I just want to check the Todd Frazier 83. That's not what I want to look at. I want to look at Ryan Healy. But I mean, I have to spell his name weirdly.
Ryan
Healy. What can you do for me? Nothing.
DJ in chat says the Ethier rakes.
I kind of
do. The Ethier was on my 24K.
So we know how that worked out. It. So
yeah. Yeah, I lost. Thanks.
First reminder.
Everyone was there. 2 weeks ago.
Todd Frazier's batting attributes are like the stock market going up. That way.
I mean, Frazier starts over Ryan Healy. I think that's your need. I think your outfield's pretty set. I think you put Ryan Healy to the bench and Todd Frazier starts.
Let me go see Orlando. Let me see.
I don't disagree with that. Again, I like the Ethier card, but at this point of the draft, you have to look at which card, if you're going to replace a starter, which card gives you the greater level of upgrade. And I think that's the Frazier card. And yeah, I'm not okay with having a guy who spells Ryan that way in the. It just weirds me out.
All right, let's see this. We can think about this for a week. We got Todd Frazier. Ryan Reilly to the bench.
It's going to be really bad if you go out and drop two games.
Bam. Are we doing the Flying Hawaiian in center, or are we doing Michael Bourne? Or is that a lefty-righty matchup determination? I think we go with the Flying Hawaiian. 62-58. Yeah, I think Victorino starts over Bourne no matter what. It doesn't have the speed.
Look at that Randall Delgado card.
So what are we doing? We're hitting the pitcher first? Sixth?
Sixth.
All right, then... Okay. I mean, do we put Alan Craig to lead this thing off, or D-Pity? I could be fine with a Pedroia, Cargo, Craig, Frazier, Gaddis.
Pitcher spot.
Victorino, Orlando Smith. Batten Smith, like ninth.
Yeah. Hoping he never comes to the plate.
You really hope he doesn't come to the plate. I mean, that's a worry. I mean, he's going to come to the plate at some point.
Yeah.
But again, then he's got that speed. We could bunt with him, get him on before Pedroia and Cargo come on.
That's a good point.
Second leadoff. Or we could move Victorino down to ninth, be a second leadoff man down there.
Yeah, no, I'm a fan of that lineup the way it is right
now. I feel like we actually have a very good lineup against lefties.
Yeah.
What stadiums are guys playing in?
Whatever one that'll get you into a game and not get challenge failed.
I've been getting a lot of challenge failed doing this actually. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, it's rough. The one complaint I've had, and again, like I said earlier in the show, I took a break from BR for a while, and I've tried to play it a little bit lately. I just give up. I mean, during the day, it's almost a pointless venture because one of two things happens. Either you don't find a game, or you find a game, but the range, the rating range is so wide that it either ends up being a cakewalk or you end up getting killed by a guy, you know, playing a 2,000 guy in your second game. It's a little better in the evenings, obviously. So it seems you got into a game right away, so that's good.
Yeah, I went with a with a minor league park? No. What are these? What are these two called? Spring training park.
Oh yeah. Can't go wrong with that.
You can always find a game in Baltimore.
That's right. Just as an update, we have received 29 fan nomination responses thus far.
Nice.
Yep.
I really don't care what happens. Rookie Salt La Mafia, winning catcher, and 89 or under. Yeah. Flashback.
That is no longer the case.
We're facing Jonathan Villar, Ted Williams, Javier Baez, David Ortiz, Joe Carter, Jason Castro, Dan Uggla, Adam Duvall, and Alex Reyes is on the mound.
Javier Baez.
And we have Hector Santiago on the mound for us. The El Chapos. We are the home team. All right, sweet. Let's not blow this. So now the move is we just get into the game and we get the bullpen going?
Absolutely. Yeah, get the bullpen going. In the very least, start that going.
All right. Yeah, immediately.
Jungle Elephant is our opponent.
Sweet.
Oh, he already called time out before I did. Yes! Boom skis. Who do we want going? We want to get Hunter Strickland and Jake McGee going? Or we want to go Baez and McGee? Baez, Coke? Thoughts?
I typically go with a guy and an upper guy. You know, just in case.
Get you want Derek Holland going?
It's not out of the question.
Let's get Derek Holland and Hunter Strickland going. Okay. Then we'll throw junk balls with Hector Santiago, because that's what people do online. Strike one. Excellent.
Yeah.
Excellent. Yo, have you guys...
Junk balls and butt cheese.
You guys been using inside cutters?
Of course. Inside cutters, the pitch.
Super effective recently.
That's a real-life OG pitch.
I know, but... I feel like in the game, it always gets left out over the plate. And then, do you know what that's called? It's called a home run. But I feel
did
like
you give up a home run?
No, it'd be super effective recently.
Jungle Elephant has almost 700 games played, is 58 games under 500.
Okay.
It has 170 quits.
Wow. That's a lot.
Guess what's going to happen?
Yeah. He currently scores 1.28 runs a game. And only plays BR because his rating is 1,500.
Yeah. Well, guess what? Ozzie Smith already paying dividends. Oh, Tadicio ball game. Ugh. Lefty-lefty situation? Do you deuce lefties low and away with lefties?
Yes.
Just make sure.
Dude's hitting 111 with Ted Williams? Come on, man.
Ted Williams.
I can understand.
Ozzie Smith paying dividends.
60 games under 500. Yeah, 170 quits in under 700 games. That's a pretty high quit percentage. Not going to lie.
Yeah, inside cutters. No jokes, folks. If we can get through an inning with Hector Santiago, I think we've done everything we need to in this life.
Yep. Then you got to get in and score 3 runs.
I'm in a home run with Petey Pablo right off the bat.
Ozzie. Glad that Ozzie working out so far. Until he gets to the plate and goes down on 3 pitches. But
he's got so much vision. It's not 3 pitches. That's not going to happen.
Contact swing all day.
That's what I'm afraid of happening with the cutter. He hit a foul, but he got all of it because it was all over the plate.
Oh, boys. I'm just seeing that now.
Hi, Chad with Hector Santiago. What are your thoughts?
Why not? Just make sure you miss up.
Haven't thrown the changeup all inning. And they get a ground or two.
Ozzie Smith.
We already won this in my mind. Ozzie Smith doing things.
And I'll tell you what, Santiago might get one more batter because I notice he has David Ortiz on deck.
He does.
Ozzie putting in work.
Do I bunt cheese with Petey Pablo?
Now hit a home run and then he'll quit.
Ooh, got a lot of it. I can't hear the game, so no, just a couple feet shy of the warning track. All right.
Ozzie pick working out so far. Red Sox says 3 assists in the first inning. Says I think so. Axel's wondering if you're going to bring David Holland into facing McGee, possibly. Leave Santiago in.
Guys, Cargo, number one pick, a.k.a. the number one stunner. Now we have a one-run lead.
Nice. Back and gone. Okay, yeah, you definitely want to get McGee warmed up now if you don't have...
No, we have Holland warmed up, not McGee. What are your thoughts?
Yeah. I don't know. At this point, Ortiz, if he's got Ortiz batting cleanup...
It's not a good Ortiz.
It's not the good Ortiz?
No, he's got 79 versus righties, 70 versus lefties.
Okay, so that's the... but he has, does he have 99 power both ways?
I couldn't say.
Yeah. I would... with a 1-0 lead and 6 outs away, I wouldn't mess around. It's just me.
Killing me here. So we're putting down Holland, bringing out McGee. Now we may have an incompletely warmed up McGee.
A little mail and visit, he'll be fine.
Oh, no, don't foul that into the first baseman. Get to the stands. Oh, God, please get to the stands. Okay. The Tijuana El Chapos. Also doesn't have a hit.
I agree with Frisk. He says the lighting on this field looks great. Okay. I agree.
So here's the call. Do we go with a possibly getting tired Hector Santiago? Or?
Wait. Here's the thing. This is the Diamond Ortiz. He's got 99 power and righties.
Okay. So.
So if you go with McGee.
How about this? Do we get wild? Here's the question. He also has no speed. Do we walk him face Joe Carter and Jason Castro?
Bring Strickland in.
Mm-hmm.
No, because do you really want to put the tying run on base with nobody out?
I'm just saying.
I know you're just saying. I understand. It's not out of the question. If it's me, I bring McGee in. I pitch him low and away with sliders, bust him in with fastballs, and if you end up walking him, then so be it. But I don't give him anything really good to hit. I just try to chintz him on the corners.
How about I leave Hector Santiago in and we'll figure out what happens?
Hey, that's all right. It's your game.
Worst case, it's a home run and we're tied.
Frisk says this guy's a bum.
Best case, he ropes one to Alan Craig for the first out of the inning.
I thought you were going to say he grounded out to Ozzie Smith.
No, thankfully, Ozzie Smith, he's done his job today.
So now you're going to go to Strickland?
We're going to go to... Joe Carter's not good versus lefties or righties,
no.
But Jason Castro is really good against righties.
Yeah. You really don't want to burn two guys here if you don't have to.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're going to have to go through the third. He's going to have his best pinch hitter in the game.
But we could go McGee right now. Or we could leave in Santiago for another one.
You could because the chances. I mean, if you pitch carefully, Joe Carter's probably not going to jump the yard.
If we can get it out here, we could leave in Santiago to face Castro because I don't want to have a righty face Castro.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, leave Santiago in here, and then you have all of your options available for the third inning. That's of course assuming you don't put three runs on the board and he quits in the bottom of the second. Nice sinker for strike one.
I'm going to try to throw an inside cutter here, and I better stay inside.
Let's see. Here it comes.
Inside enough. Screen. Todd Frazier making the play. All right. We can bring in McGee to face Castro. Or not.
Nah, stick with Santiago.
Okay.
Keep all your bullets in the gun for the third inning. Not unlike Buck Showalter.
Wow, he did it. We still also have, don't forget, guys, Benoit in the pen.
That's right. Your old Mother Hubbard and Joaquin Benoit is still in the cupboard.
Santiago getting tired.
What a great line that was, Major League. Fantastic.
Lefty-lefty low and away curves are so nasty.
They are.
Also brings out a beautiful swing from the computer batter.
Thank you, Axel. Axel complimenting me on my Buck Showalter jab.
I want to Cheddar up top. I think other Chris quit because he didn't want
to
hear your nonsense.
No, he had to take his dog out, according to the message I received.
Oh, so that's you said it because you knew it was safe. You didn't do it because it was hard. You did it because it was safe and easy.
No, I did it because the opportunity presented itself. And I will surely, once this stream is archived on YouTube, which you can watch by going to youtube.com/thatsportsgamer, I will definitely find the timestamp and definitely tweet it at him.
Yeah, guys, don't forget to follow us on Twitter, @thatsportsgamer. Chris number one is @MillenniumOS. Sorry, Chris. Chris number two, @SnaggleJ.
It's okay. I'm okay with being Chris number two.
Evan Gaddis, you can follow him on Twitter.
Whatever. El Gattiso?
No, it's the white bear in Spanish. I forget what it is. El Blanco Queso? That's white cheese.
Blanco Oso?
Yes.
Yeah. That's right. Yeah, hey, listen, Millennium is the OG Chris to the show. I'm okay with being Chris number two. Like, as I've said many times, I'm just happy to be here. Red Sox is letting me know it's about an hour and 34 minutes into the stream. I wrote down the time, which was 12:03 local time when it happened. So,
all right.
Thank you, Red Sox.
We got Alani Chisinal coming in to hit.
Sweet. Do it up.
See, already paying off of dividends.
Pop a jack here.
Yo, if Alani Chisinal pops a jack, I'm going to be pretty excited. Power swing at a ball in the dirt.
Boom!
Imagine. Get up. Oh, just got under it. Or did I not just get under it? Just got under it. Puts the right fielder in the middle of the track. Uh-oh, flying Hawaiian. Flying Hawaiian with the bunt, Ched? Yes, he does. Run, sir. Run. You only have 69 speed. What are you doing? That's a terrible idea. Bunt, Ched. It works sometimes. That was a bad idea. All right. We got Fugla over here. All these guys suck, so I don't care. We'll bring in Ben Weezer.
And as we've been talking about, guys, Bullpen Banter is doing an award show.
Community awards, some would call it.
Community awards, that's right.
Hold on, did you say we're doing an awards show? Apparently.
Apparently we are. That's you know, it's a thing. It's a thing that's happening. Anyway, if you head to the link in the chat, you can nominate your favorite player at all the positions. Flashbacks under 90, flashbacks over 90, favorite bunt cheeser, and favorite legend card. And on the December 26th episode of Bullpen Banter, we will be revealing the top four nominees for all the categories and open it up with some Twitter poll action. Oh, no. No.
Whose idea was it to draft this bum-ass Benoit?
No.
His slider missed by a mile and a half.
No. No. That's
Dan Fugla. Doing work. Could have had V-Mart. Just
saying. Wow. Benoit, trash. Good luck, Phillies fans.
Can we get Hunt, my man Hunter back up?
Yeah, I think so.
Might need to think about warming up Holland. Might need some link.
Who's he got coming in for Reyes? Is the question.
For some reason, he's got Bryce Harper on his bench.
Oh, the rookie Bryce Harper?
I don't know.
Wow. BR strats of the yin-yang.
75-48.
EJ says, that's why you don't use meter pitching. Yeah, you know, I have to admit, I tried the analog pitching because I saw so many guys, so many upper ratings streamers who use it, and I absolutely hate it.
Can't do it.
I had to catch myself from using an expletive there. I hate it. I can't stand the analog pitching. Again, you know, I would use the pulse pitching if I didn't feel like a cheap noob using it.
Love pulse pitching. Gotta say, love pulse pitching.
I love it too, but I always feel like I'm cheating the game by using it. So I use the meter. This is the first year I've used the meter pitching full.
Yeah, everyone's doing strike zone cam and
analog pitching. Analog. I hate the strike zone cam too. While pitching, I just not a fan.
Wow.
Oh no! Did you just get jacked again?
No.
Okay. Wow. Whoa. Whoa. Welcome to Bullpen Banter After Hours.
I got away with one there.
Oh, yes, you did. Yes, you did. Yeah, analog's trash. But that's just me. But there's something to be said for the fact that a lot of the guys you see who are out there in public who have very high ratings all use the same pitching style. Maybe it's
broken. Maybe it's broken.
Maybe it's broken, yep. You know what it is? It's cheese. It's absolutely cheese.
Meadow, I feel like it was. He broke his controller. Oh, give me 40 minutes, 30 seconds, and I'm going to square him. Square him right out of this game. Nah, he's back. Weak.
I do. I agree with Red Sox. I absolutely love the fisheye batting. It's probably one of the most underrated additions this year. I've gotten away from using it. More so because I feel like I just hit better with the offset zoom camera, but I love the fisheye camera. I think
this guy's bringing in Jacquin Benoit.
Sweet.
What happens if I pay back him?
You gotta walk
back
it off, man.
The pay. That's a short fly ball strike.
Walk it off. This is where you need bets.
This is where you know who you need right now? Ozzie Smith to play. Yeah, I'm going to slap one right up the center. Fred with a single. Here we go.
Yeah, Gaming Freak says he used to say the same thing about analog pitching. And it's beast.
I think there was something messed up with it.
Oh, like I said, I have way too many innings in the season to start changing the way I pitch now.
Got under it. God damn.
Come on now.
Okay, Pete Pablo. Use that axe bat and let's do something here. Will axe bat be in the game next year? I wanted to check that swing. I just wanted them to know that I appreciated the pitch. And I swung at another one even worse off than the first one.
Come on, you're on tilt here. You need to rein it in a little bit.
Yeah, that's what it is. That's the problem right now. On tilt. Not on fleek is what we need to be right now.
No, we need to be lit on fleek. You need your batting game on point right now.
Oh, solid rope to left. Teddy ball game standing right there.
As he often is. As he often is. Oh, that was he probably didn't mean to leave that fastball there to Pedroia. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to the top of the fourth inning. It is 1-1. I would cast the game, but I'm on an 8-second delay. Just like everybody else.
So many decisions right now.
Yeah. You got to bring McGee in to face the Teddy ball game.
But the problem is, Javier Baez crushes left-handed pitchers.
Yeah. That's the downside.
I can't hit a spot for the life of me right now. There we go.
Maybe, yeah. It's all right. You wanted to use Coke or McGee here because if you only get one batter, you don't want to waste Holland because he's probably your highest stamina reliever.
Can't hit a spot. Can't hit a spot, guys. And you know what's going to happen when I hit a spot, right? Exactly. Exactly! Bullpen banter is where that pitch landed up.
Oh, no. Oh, boys.
Guys, we are never using this draft theory again.
Back. Hey. It's because you didn't listen to 100% of my decisions. You know, I bought one of them.
Problem is, this guy didn't chase all the pitchers that I wanted to chase.
No. I bought one of those Logitech keyboards that has the touchpad on the right side, and I kind of enjoy it. Just FYI. Yeah, it's kind of nice. No, it's got a wireless receiver. And ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the stream. The man himself, Millennium OS.
I mean, When dogs have to do stuff, dogs have to do stuff. Am I right or am I right?
All you're missing is being infuriated in TJ's direction at how he blew this game.
He's down 2-1. Oh, my God.
Some Benoit. Jerk told me to take Jacquin Benoit.
Benoit. Benoit gave up a he had Benoit in, save situation.
Couldn't throw a strike for his life.
Home run to
Fugla.
Dan Ugla.
I don't know, guys. I mean, Joaquin Benoit, literally known as one of the better relievers in the game.
Yeah. Known by who?
Was that live series Dan Ugla, by the way, or was it actually at least
Dan Ugla? I hope it was flashback Dan Ugla.
I hope so, too.
For the love of God, please be flashback Dan Ugla.
And Red Sox is correct. You did miss some a little bit of Buck Showalter trashing. I'll make sure to link you the timestamp.
Good old Buck Showalter. How long are you going to hold Zach Britton in next time, buddy?
Hey, I'm happy with how it ended. When Ubaldo came in that game, I said, okay.
We're never playing VR again, guys. Never again.
Is that why it was on Bullpen Banter episode 2 and then has not been on since?
Probably.
Yeah. I don't think it went well then either. Oh, no. No, not the plunk job. Oh, man. Poor Dan Ugla takes it right in the melon almost. Wow.
You think this is going to be Jungle Elephant's 171st quit?
Probably. What? Come on, Blue. First off.
I think, judging by what 312th win, Dan Ugla is, he does have a live series card, if I'm not mistaken.
He's got a free agent card, I believe.
Yeah.
Jesus. Can't get a strike.
Top market gainer right now, according to Daddy Leagues. 62 overall Jordan Danks going for 75K.
Jordan Danks kind of a goat, though.
He is, yeah. Unbelievable. Yeah, Dan Ugla, free agent, 61. You can currently pick him up for 2 stubs.
Which would be a good play, because you can drop him for 12.
Yeah. Yeah. He, 27 contact against righties, 22 contact against lefties, 96 discipline, 27 plate vision.
96 discipline, that's going to get you tickets on your, what's his name? On your Josh Donaldson. So think about that.
25 clutch, 38 bunt, though. So if you need a bunt in a pinch.
Yeah.
He's been sold 4,818 times this year. Which,
that's a lot.
It's way too much. Most of people just dumping them for 2 stubs.
Maybe we get this pause timer. It'd be good.
It's not out of the question.
What happened here?
Well, we could go back and forth about that all day.
Look, Adam Eaton, great player. Got traded for Lucas Giolito. And you know what he did? Just got pinch hit out of the game. Wow.
Danny Espinosa.
Just signed with the Angels, if I'm not mistaken.
Nope, you are definitely not mistaken.
Ooh, I thought they had a second baseman, but apparently I was wrong. Danny Espinosa, though, monster stash game.
His stash game is on point. All right, well, you need 3 runs.
Well, we got Bastardo in the game, so.
Man. That's the kind of, let's see what happens. That's the kind of respect he has for you.
Jesus.
I have faith, TJ.
I have faith myself.
I think what he was referencing is that he has faith that you're not going to smash your controller.
This is a nice new controller. I don't want to break it.
I don't have faith in you swinging low outside sliders. With
That slider over the middle that you just missed, though. Yeah. Man. Oof.
Just got to get some base runners here. We got Alan Craig up, you know, so that's good. Whoa! Wow! He gets that call? Umpire.
Did you just strike out on 4 straight sliders with Carlos Gonzalez? I know we're on delay.
He did, yeah.
3 of them in the exact same spot.
Yeah, that was bad.
The 4th one was a little further away.
There was the one that he just missed that he should have hit over that player's trust sign in right center, where he just hit that ball with Alan Craig.
Oh, Todd Frazier!
Wait! Your selected field and doing this?
Yeah,
killing me.
Atrocious. Call me Smalls.
Oh, Frazier. Oh, how did you miss that?
Because my thumb magically goes down all the time. God, I hate this game. So much. So much.
Next week, ladies and gentlemen, bullpen banter will be called mutt banter.
NBA 2K17, my team banter.
Yeah. Gaddis, though, for... Don't you hate that you gave up those two extra runs now?
I hate that they're gonna let me get so close.
Yeah. Matt Kemp. Does he leave Bastardo in? Can't. He can't.
He does, Matt Kemp. Welcome to the Dublévé. Highway to the Dublévé zone. Phase zone.
Oh.
Go, Matt Kemp. 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 Yes. Oh.
This is one of those times where the stream being on a delay really sucks.
Save the drama for yo mama.
Wow, hey guys, if somebody could make a GIF out of TJ on that play.
Go! Let's go!
Somebody's got to GIF that immediately.
Flying Hawaiian, love you, but you know what? I can't tell if Michael Bourne has more speed than you, but it's all good. Let's go.
Man.
One time. Let's go. Send him. Do we send him? I don't think we send him. We send him. Bad animation. Get in. Get down. Gotta get down. Yes. 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 Evan Gaddis, player of the game, folks.
You're welcome.
Yeah. Funny how you can literally, like, not even kidding. 3 minutes ago, he said he was never playing VR again.
And that was after I hit the home run with Gaddis, because, like, I knew the game was going to, like, put me this close and make me lose.
Yeah, now he's, like, literally, if baseball purists were watching this stream, they would say that you have no respect for the game due to excessive celebrations.
Do you feel this? Shaking over here.
Oh. Ladies and gentlemen in the chat, that is your VR tutorial.
That's how you do it. You know, you bring in your best player, blow the lead, yep. Then just give him another 3 runs, and then, then you just blow him out. That's why you pick your home field.
Yep. And for you aspiring content creators out there, now you have a full-fledged clip video all ready for tomorrow.
What literally just happened? What did I tell you guys? Alan Craig... monster against lefties. Matt Kemp, monster against lefties. El Queso Blanco, monster against lefties. Also, Millennium, while you were gone, we couldn't think of Evan Gaddis' nickname, White Bear. Instead, we went with White Cheese.
You meant Polar Bear, man. Big boy.
Good stuff.
Playing another one?
I mean,
you gotta test your luck now, right?
I'm doing a lot to try to win this. Who is it?
Randall Delgado.
Yeah, doing a lot to try to win this Randall Delgado right here.
Randall Delgado.
So, are we doing another one? Are we gonna do it?
I mean, I felt like that was a really good place to end this the stream, but let's do it. Are we going back to Palm? Date Palm Field? That's a terrible... Those are literally just 3 words. Date Palm Field.
Has anyone watched Raw tonight?
Yeah, I have.
So, big ups to The New Day, longest reigning tag team champions in WWE/F history.
Won 2 tag team triple threat matches tonight.
Yep. Now we can finally take the belts off them and give them to someone else next week.
The Ascension. We need to get them ascended to prime level.
No, they're on SmackDown. That doesn't work.
Is the Monday Night Football game over? Because I have a Jeremy Shockey to give away.
It is not over.
You know what they say? It ain't over till it's over. And you know what? We just proved that last game. All right, we're facing against Melky Cabrera, Joseph Mauer, King Fielder's son, Prince Fielder, Carlos Beltran, Colton Wong, Nick Markakis, Jonathan Villar, who, again, we faced last game, Ryan Sandberg, and Mike Bolsinger. And we have... And Ivan.
AZ D-backs for life in the chat says he likes how you plunked a guy and then came back.
Yo, I hit... Yeah. Yo, I straight up nailed Dan Uglin. Payback is a female dog.
That's right.
I mean, what are you paying back? Wouldn't it be him paying back for plunking him?
No, he hit the home run.
What is that? Why is that payback?
Because he should not have hit that home run. It should be GG.
What TJ is trying to say is that he loves the Texas Rangers because that's the kind of crap that they do.
Texas long ball is what we call them.
Yeah.
Get that pen going.
I mean, if that's what you think, if you think it's the Rangers' fault that Batista slides dirty every time?
No, stop. The only thing I hated in the whole situation is that they waited till his last at bat of the weekend before they threw at him.
Yep.
You're going to throw at him, you do it right away, and then it's over with. You don't wait until the eighth inning of the third game and then do it then. Like, that was Bush League.
So there's no comeback, no comeuppance.
Yep.
Yeah. Well, no, not even. It's just it'd be done with it. And, like, you know, don't leave it like that, because then that's all people are talking about until the next time.
Yeah.
You do it on Friday.
You break them in Sunday, spring training. Over.
I mean, I'm glad Joey Bats is gone. When I heard in the news today they were talking to him again, I'm like, pray God, leave him alone, please. Let him go away.
Oh, this is super prime Joe Mauer. One out, do I just walk him?
Also, Jungle Elephant, I can confirm he just broke his controller and deleted his MLB The Show.
All right. Joe Mauer, never... single. I guess I'm the guy at GG. Do I have my messages app?
Let's see. This guy you're playing is 38-18 on the season. He has zero quits, so he's in there for the long haul.
We're bringing in Jake McGee right now. We're already into the pen. I'm just saying, we're not playing around this time. We're not Hector Santiago two innings in again.
No.
And he just brings Edwin Encarnacion off the bench. Okay. That's game how on. We're playing. Game on!
But is a crappy flashback, Edwin?
Probably.
No, that's got to be live series, Edwin, I would think. Actually, you know what? I take that back. Live series, Edwin, is not somebody you'd start with the bench on.
Agreed.
Yeah, I didn't see his come up to the plate overlay to see if it had which card it was. Or is it only the diamond cards that they show that they're actually a diamond card? You know how the diamond cards, like when they come up to the plate, yeah, it shows diamond? Yeah, up above their name, the little diamond.
Pick the wrong
logo.
Pitch. Hey, guys, if you pick the wrong pitch, just step off.
Uh-oh.
Just saying.
Okay, he fouled it off at least.
He's fouling off a lot of stuff, and I'm not really liking it.
That's no good.
So I'm going to throw one, like, way outside just to see.
Well, I don't disagree.
Right. He chased it. We got a little pop-up, Sonny. Flying Hawaiian. It's a golden.
Hey, Mills, can I ask you an NHL-related
question? You can absolutely ask me an NHL-related question, please.
How did Foot work out in your draft, in your franchise? Is he all right? Is he worth it?
Did you step on
so far, too? So good. We're still on the beginning of the second year, so...
Okay.
No results yet.
But he was worthy of...
Yes, very much okay. So.
Did yeah, you, I'm picking sixth in my draft, too, so...
Did you step on Mateau?
Oh, that's a bad hockey pun.
Great player.
Well, he scored one of the most famous goals in New York Rangers history. Or was it Islanders history? Rangers history, 93, in the Eastern Conference final game six, overtime.
Players met.
This guy bunt chasing you?
He's pretending like he's going to, but I just made him pop out of right field, so we're golden.
But see, that the guys who square, that's still bunt cheesy because your infielders charge.
They don't charge till the pitch starts coming in?
Yeah, but they can still get them into that charging animation. Ball down the line past them. That is that's basically bunt cheesing.
I bunt cheese him.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, that guy GG'd me first. Wow. Good man.
What's he fan?
His right fielder missed the play. Petey Pablo gets second base.
Alternate controller and linked up the Bluetooth for the one that he broke. Oh, boys. That's bad.
I'm going to take a pitch while I reply to that guy's message. And then I'm going to car go into the outfield with this pitch.
Oh, man.
Nope, that didn't work, didn't work, didn't work. Get back. It was a good rip. I've been ripping balls, I'm not going to lie. That's been confused with tripping balls.
That is a completely different show.
Oh, did I have played Jungle Elephant before, apparently.
Okay.
On 7:30, I sent him a GG. That wasn't him sending me a GG, that was me. From 7:30 at 12:17 p.m.
Okay.
Get through. No? Okay, we got two outs, we're on third.
My Patriots with a 79-yarder to Chris Hogan.
I thought you were going to say 79-yard touchdown field goal.
It is, 79-yard touchdown to Chris Hogan.
Extra point.
To Chris Hogan, who, if you were in Millennium Stream on Sunday, dudes in the chat were quite salty that you did not sign him.
Yeah, I'm not going to sign. No, I like how he got better.
Yo, this dude may not know how to play this game. I hit a grounder to the second baseman, and he flipped it to the shortstop to allow me to score a run.
Whoops.
And then ran the second, force out at second. Nice. He forgot there was nobody on first.
All right. We got to run.
Anyway, yeah. People were roaring at Mills in the chat. Chris Hogan.
Yeah. Guys, a lot of Patriots fan in the chat, one of them.
I have one run on no hits.
Hey, that's all right.
Who did we end up picking up, Snagel? It was we were going to go Marlon Brown, and I know we got Kubik as a fourth.
Yeah.
Oh, who was it?
Oh man. You know what?
I don't remember.
Did you get Zdeno Chara?
Different sport.
I thought we were talking about hockey. What happened to that?
We're talking about Madden now. Keep up.
Did you get Moncrief?
No. Wasn't Moncrief. Although I think Moncrief was available. And I think Brian Hartline. Brian Hartline.
Oh, Hartline's who we got.
Red Sox, the real MVP in the chat. That's right. Hartline.
Ben?
Who you originally said was too old, but then you come around on him.
Yeah, because everyone was 30, yeah. Dude, 100%. Dude, Red Sox remembers every bit of every one of my franchise streams. Dude is clutch.
You know who's almost clutch? Justin Upton for this guy.
Ooh.
Question is, do I have zero faith left in... what's this guy's name? Do I have zero faith in Benoit?
To be fair, it's either he's really clutch, or, I mean, literally it was yesterday, so maybe we just have really bad memories.
Oh, I have terrible memories. Because
I was there. I was watching it live.
Yeah, we were getting all kinds of help.
I was there, and I couldn't for the life of me remember. That was yesterday, man.
Dude, I don't remember what I had for dinner.
Technically, it was 2 days ago for you, Chris K. with the Canada.
It is technically Tuesday where I am, yes. That's a fair assumption. Or assessment of what day it is. And it's still snowing out as it has been for the last 25 hours.
I can't stand snow. I hate snow.
I shoveled twice already today, and the kids were home.
The only thing I'm going to shovel is food into my mouth.
Yeah, I do that after I shovel the snow.
I got to get those carbs up.
What the heck did you just do with Ozzie Smith?
The throw was going to be off.
Nah, you let it happen. It's Ozzie Smith.
I was in the yellow.
But yellow does not mean it's going to be off.
I believe it's going to be off.
Especially not with a great defender.
You know what it is? You miss 100% of the throws you don't make.
It's true. That's why we bat Lonnie Chisenhall.
Yeah. Hey, you get into the innings, so that's fine. All right. Put some runs on the board here. Let's go. Get Joaquin Benoit warmed up.
Already got him. Holland also warming up.
Ooh, who is going to be the closer?
Ooh. Almost got a single down the line. But did not. What happened to Ben Hartline? Is he not also a player? I'm just gonna
Ben Hartline?
Yeah, I think so. I'm just gonna keep hitting grounders to second base. He apparently can't handle them. hold on.
AZ D-backs for life is asking how long you're going to be streaming.
Not much longer.
4 or 5 more Battle Royale games, I think. He said somewhere around 2 a.m., 3 a.m.
I thought it was
till
he gets eliminated.
More importantly, who is playing second base for him?
I don't know. Who is?
Oh, it's Ryan Sandberg. Oh, this guy just sucks. Bam.
In your face.
Oh, it's Ryan Sandberg.
Sandberg's car is underrated, meaning it should be higher rated than it is.
How about he threw it to the shortstop before, and now on a ground ball hit right to him, he threw it almost into the stands.
Hey, TJ, you know what I just remembered?
What's up?
What we were going to do, and we forgot all about it, was...
hit doubles with Paolo Orlando and drive in Shane Victorino? All
right. No, the cards that we wanted thing. Remember we talked about that and
there wasn't a thing
for it. You didn't find it.
No, it doesn't exist apparently.
Okay.
Sadly, that was a ground rule double, so we did not score the run.
Let's go, Ozzy. Clutch it up here.
Ozzy, so clutch, guys.
Bunt cheese.
The clutchest of Smiths. Yo, I am making Ryan Sandberg look like the biggest bunt. You know what it does?
Oh, wow.
You know what it is? Bad spelling of the word name Ryan. I don't know why these guys can't do it correctly. If they could, they'd be winning these games, probably. Did he just go power swing with Petey Pablo and rip one down the line? Yes, he did. We need to get so many runs to feel confident right now. Like 100.
No lead is safe.
And I rolled with no lead. Excellent.
No lead ever saved.
We're going to need that. Someone's going to need to give me timestamps of the time for that.
I've already wrote a note down of my list of things to do tomorrow.
Thank you.
No problem. It's on there. It's not at the top, but it's on there.
That's all that matters. This guy's got Danny Santana. He's living a life just like a movie star.
Joaquin Benoit in the game, trying to redeem himself.
Holy God, I hate Joaquin Benoit.
Oh no, Danny, bomb incoming. Oh boys, that's not where you want to leave that pitch to anybody.
Yo, Benoit is straight up probably off this team. I might start thinking about playing that guy who we picked just to waste a pick.
Was that Josh Phelps?
No. It was Jake Smith.
Oh, Jake Smith.
Remember when we drafted Jake Smith?
Hey, you got nothing
Billy
to lose.
Butler?
Listen, he's getting the worst he can do is hit a solo job. Whose idea was it to draft Benoit? I think it was all three of us were all over Benoit.
Oh, but. Jungle Elephant was watching a stream.
Good.
Love it.
Does he hate our guts now?
He loves us. Thought that was hilarious.
Good.
I'm sorry for hitting Dandaba. That was uncouth of me. I don't know what uncouth means, but it sounds like that's like a right kind of word for that. Hey, guess what? Benoit getting tired after 5 pitches. This dude is straight trash, folks. I couldn't get beast closer. Now we got Edwin Encarnacion up with a chance to tie it. And I'm going to throw another really, really awful slider.
Please stop doing that.
All I want is a ground ball double play. Is that too much to ask for?
I think at this point you would be satisfied if he kept it in the yard.
Got the K. just going to throw this dude junk on the ground. Or not, because apparently pitchers don't want to go where I want to throw him. Evan Gattis. The white cheese. Making Paolo Orlando player of the game.
Nice. GG. Two easy W's. I'm pretty sure I called him a bum at Top Frisk. Ouch. Okay. Hey, it's all good.
Hey, we got that Randall Delgado card.
Nice. Isn't it? Is it two? I thought it was three wins.
No, I think two for the first one, right?
Oh, okay.
Nope, maybe three. God damn it.
Yeah, Millennium. See,
oh, well, my mic is muted. Crap. What's going on, guys?
Hey.
I thought you left.
No, I didn't leave.
I thought you wanted to make sure we get this Randall Delgado card.
Yeah, see, now that they changed it, it's 3, 6, 9, 12, and 20.
3, 6, 9?
Yeah.
What song is that?
I don't know.
MDOT's going to know for me.
Was that Rey Mysterio's finishing move? No, that was a 6-1-9.
6-1-9.
Which, by the way, Cesaro does it now.
Got the friend request. Guys.
Terrible.
Guys, got the friend request from Jungle Elephant.
Do it up. Play him all the time.
No
her day.
Asked. That guy's getting a follow. That guy's
getting all day, her day.
If you can find me a Twitter name for Jungle Elephant, I would love to hit him up on Twitter. Thank him for the great game. Left-handed pitcher. Okay. What are we doing crazy? Are we going to lead off Craig? Do it. I don't know. Petey Pablo can also rip against lefties. We're going to go Craig lead off. Crazy idea right here. He's got Trout, Pence, Luis Gonzalez, Joe Mauer, Joe Panic, Elvis Andrews, Alex Gordon, Clint Robinson, Tyler Anderson. Let me tell you what he's got for there, folks. I don't know if you can see. That's a whole lot of L's, not including the one I'm going to hand him.
Ooh. Snap.
Sick burn.
So good, I even figured out the right hand to use to make the camera work. Yeah. This guy's Canada Stars right here, though.
Let's see.
Beast Swanson approved. Gonna warm up D. Holland to face all these lefties. I'm gonna warm up Pedro Baez, because really, I don't know how I feel about this. Jacquin Benoit.
You just can't pitch. It's unfortunate.
Guys, can we just talk about how dope it is to have Bronson Arroyo?
Sure.
Kind of upset he doesn't have the dreads. Or not the dreads, the cornrows.
B. Swanson 8 is this guy. He's 340 and 520 on the season with 252 quits in 860 games.
At Danny J. Good, too. Go thank him for a great game.
Okay.
That's the Jungle Elephant. He's watching a stream. Great guy.
Sweet.
My new number one fan. I'm also a fan of him.
Oh, wait, is he watching the stream right now?
Yeah, I don't know how he's watching it, but he's responded to me in PlayStation messages.
He can watch it on PlayStation. There's a PlayStation app.
Is that how that works?
Yep.
I mean, yes. I don't know how that works.
Yeah.
What if I just throw this guy a humpback 12-6? Oh, so nasty. Then do I goose him with a 84-mile-per-hour fastball? Yes, sir. 87. I was so far off.
Does your stream show up, though, if you're streaming, like, with an Elgato?
Great question. I don't think so.
I don't think so either. I think it would show that you're playing the game. He probably recognized your username.
It's pretty famous. If you're a friend of somebody, you see if they're streaming from their PlayStation. But if you go into the Twitch app, I mean, obviously you'll see anyone that's streaming that game. Yeah. You can see people streaming that game from, like, the game highlight screen, whether they're on Elgato or PlayStation.
He just added me, so he wasn't a friend before, but he was answering as if he was watching the game.
Red Sox throwing this guy under the bus. I got to say, I thoroughly dig B. Swanson 8's uniforms and logo. Repping the Baseball Canada official merchandise. Love it.
They're pretty sweet. All right, he's got a lefty. We've gotten home field advantage all three games. And we have. Oh, look at this. We forced a Tyler Anderson versus Alan Craig matchup.
Oh, baby.
Do you feel it? Can you feel it? Huh? Yeah, you're sure quite balanced. What if he just four balls him? You know what I'm saying? Oh, and I hit it mile high to the catcher. Please drop this. How did I blow that?
This guy, by the way, in 860 games, has a .228 batting average. Just throwing that out there.
Would you say, oh, baby, he likes it raw?
Yeah,
I think that's what you would say.
Pretty sure I would not say that.
I would. That's how he bats. Raw. No talent.
No batting gloves, is what you mean. I want to just go oppo down the line.
Not asking much.
Oh, another catcher pop up. Yes, crushing it. 2-for-2.
She really stopped doing that.
2-for-2.
This Monday Night Football game is over. I'm guessing. You know what was over? Yesterday, my fantasy playoffs matchup. Just saying.
I suck at this game.
There are five English people or English speaking people streaming this game, including you.
Are three of them on the stream right now?
I was streaming it beforehand. Does that count?
Sure.
I know Coral's doing it.
Coral. But is
Coral
having season ending awards like we are?
Probably not.
Woo! Derek Holland with the nasty, nasty.
Probably not. Oh, no. Delete. Oh, I typed the stupid link twice. That was dumb, Chris. Why would you do that?
Alan Craig playing defense.
Hey, I'm right here.
Like an Alan Craig.
I'm such a bum.
It's weird that Canada Chris has a K and not the C.
Yeah. Sorry. Blame my mom.
Sure.
Oh, man. I forgot to send you the screen cap.
God.
Of the conversation. Best. I'm gonna toss it in the Discord now.
Oh yeah, did your mom say something? What does your mom think of the show?
She loves it.
Did she like Snaggle and Sports and Snaggle?
She never gave me any feedback. She said she watched a few minutes of it and then she was making finger rolls. So
no feedback on the Sports and Snaggle show, but she likes Bullpen Banter. What is the difference between those two shows?
Neither of them.
Baseball.
Yeah.
Baseball.
Oh, baseball. Oh, yeah. Got it.
She's not a fan of people talking about the Canadian exchange rate.
Yeah. So, for those guys who were here last week,
it was 2 weeks
there
ago.
Was Mills and TJ talked about how they have a hate relationship, mostly hate, but they make it work for the show.
Yeah.
And so my mom messaged me on Facebook and said, and I quote, "Hello, son. I watched a video of you on some sort of video show. I couldn't see you, but could hear your voice. Is that normal?" I responded, "Yes, Mom. That's the way it works. TJ controls the video part, and we just talk."
"Yes, Mother."
My mother responded, "Oh, okay. Those other two boys seem nice. I heard them say they don't get along, but you can't tell that on the show."
I mean,
your mom's the best. I'm not going to lie.
So what I got to do now is when I go up there for Christmas dinner, I got to look and see. I think she may be subbed to youtube.com/thatsportsgamer.
First off, if she's not, you need to fix that.
Yeah, I'll definitely hack her Facebook for sure.
That's not how any of that works.
I'm going to hack her Facebook to subscribe to TJ's YouTube?
Yeah.
Well, I'm gonna follow
she
you
can just
Facebook.
Go to facebook.com/thatsportsgamer and just follow me there.
I'm going to hack her all
just
of
like
her
you guys can.
Media.
Make sure you that up. I'm also hack up on that
all
Instagram. Yeah, up on that Instagram piece. Instagram.com/thatsportsgamer.
I'm going to hack my mom's Facebook
to give
to follow
TJ. Yeah. That's how it works. How the internet works?
I'm pretty sure that's how the internet works.
Yeah. Listen, my extent of the internet is I open Discord and I click a button and then I do this. That's it.
And then supposedly you sit in the chat all day long.
No, I don't sit in the chat all day long.
That's what my name says.
Who said that?
Sit in one chat.
I said the two of you were in the voice chat. I was
We're not like, in the voice chat.
Anytime you go into our Discord, like you see Chris and TJ both just sitting in voice chat, and I'm like, man, there must be something going on. What's going on in here?
Your thing must be broken. We're never in voice chat.
Yeah, exactly. We're never in voice chat. Yeah. Unless we're doing this or something else. I do have my Discord open way, like, all the time, but never in the voice chat.
Yeah, it's just one of those windows now that gets open in the morning.
Yeah. Well, I find if I keep it open on the computer, I don't get a notification every time one of you say something.
Handy. Lonnie Chisenhall back in the game. Something was happening with that woman's head behind him.
I go to 3 or 4 websites. OS, Twitter. Nice. I like how he has OS at the first. Twitter, Twitch, ESPN.
I mean, just follow me in Millennium, and you don't have to go to OS.
Those are 3 of the 4 first bookmarks on my browser. I do not go to ESPN. ESPN is absolutely trash.
Not a fan of the ESPN Zone?
No. Well, plus, I'm in Canada, so I go to TSN, which is basically the same thing.
Never heard of it.
You know what? I used to have ESPN and used to love it. And then when they redesigned their site, it was last year or the year before, I can't stand it anymore. I always have a hard time finding the articles I wanted to read, things like that. And I was always a big fan of their various chats that they usually did. Get a little more unfiltered content that way.
I can't think of the last time that I went to a website to just go chill out on the website and peruse what's going on. Other than Twitter. I go to Twitter, and then I can go to a website from there.
I browse on Twitch quite frequently.
Every once in a while. I did see someone streaming Out of the Park 2 nights ago, or last night, and I went there and chatted up for a little bit. They were the Let's Go Tribe SB Nation page. They were testing some stuff out, so it's more than happy.
I've been this close to streaming Franchise Hockey Manager like 3 or 4 times because I have it, I own it, I play it. I just haven't been able to actually stream it yet.
It's a pretty good game from what I hear.
It is. It's a very good game. I'm very enamored with it.
Yeah, I hear it's pretty good.
The question is it one of your top 3 favorite games of the year?
I refuse to speak about my sports game of the year right now because many, many places are asking for my opinion.
Under embargo.
I'm under embargo for review.
That Monday Night Football game's over. I should probably give away this mutt card. Jeremy,
I won't talk about my favorite sports game of the year, but you know what? If you tune in to my YouTube channel on Thursday, you'll be able to find out.
I don't want
to. There you go.
YouTube.com/SnaggleJ.
Love the promotion, SnaggleJ.
My favorite games of 2016.
Also, a great 2016 gamers buying guide. I watched that today.
Thank you. I saw some of your feedback, and I appreciate that. I'm kind of bummed out that I can't get the Pat the NES Punks book until next year, but I'm getting it. It's a...
Also, let me recommend 1001 video games to play before you die.
Yeah, I believe I have that here somewhere. You must play before you die. I have it here somewhere.
Also, Console Wars sitting right next to it.
Yeah, I'm reading that for the second time. I kind of read it quickly through the first time. It was my Flying on the Plane book, so I just kind of flipped through it, and now I'm kind of reading it again and for a little more comprehension purposes.
Paolo Orlando out here doing work. I think he might go 3 on this play.
Red Sox, obviously, doing some kind of drugs today, says Overwatch is overall game of the year. I have to disagree with that. I know it won at whatever that show was, that sham, the Game Awards, but...
82 speed. I don't know who's left fielder is. We're not going to go.
Oh, you're good.
And he threw it offline. God. 2 outs. Alan Craig facing a lefty. GG, folks. Is this Sean Doolittle? Crap.
I watched the Christmas guide over the weekend. Thank you. Appreciate it.
I dropped a like on it. And I don't drop a like on many videos.
I drop a like on all your videos. You know why? Because they're all legit. I drop a like on all of Mills' videos, too, because they're all legit good videos.
I thought you were going to say because you both have the same first name.
Technically not.
I mean, pronunciation-wise.
Yes, fair enough.
It's neither there or there.
No, it's neither there
nor there. I absolutely bully people into likes, so it's okay.
Nah, you don't.
I can't believe I just blew that. Who is his left fielder that I screwed up and should have run it on?
didn't notice.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. Very nice. Baez, GOAT. I love this Luis Gonzalez card, by the way. I know it's not on your team. This bad karma there.
Yep. You are the karma chameleon.
Karma chameleon. Everybody. We karma and go.
El Caso Blanco. Monster out here on the base. Ball field of defensive goodness. Jake McGee. Trying to keep Jacquin Benoit from ever having to pitch again. Joaquin Phoenix is what I like to call him.
I think that was Luis Gonzalez's card. Yeah, but, Red Sox.
His left fielder is Luis Gonzalez. God, and I could have made that. God, it's so angering.
That's the one thing about BR. You really have to play a pretty much flawless game, unless you're able to come back.
Unless you can just drop four in the bottom of the fourth. I mean, not everybody can. Just saying.
No. Not everybody can.
Okay. Sean Doolittle in. Cargo up. Try and hit this double down the third baseline. And then we got Petey Pablo up after that.
Sounds like I smell walk-off.
I'm really terrible against lefty-lefty with cargo. Wow. Okay, gotta be a little more patient here. Doolittle's gotta be getting tired.
Oh, wow. That fastball, though.
Yeah.
Come on, Pedroia. Do something. Oh.
That was pretty nice.
Off the bag. Oh, man.
I just
double
checks.
Double robbery.
I just checks one, stole it HBP.
Oh, no.
Runners on first and second. Evan Gattis. Oh,
that was so cheesy.
I got Evan Gattis up with a 2-0 count. Runners on first and second.
Let's go. GG's.
Roped to deep center. That's Trout. No, get back. Back. Solid. Pretty good throw.
Okay. Yeah, you don't want to get that guy burned at third. You still get scoring position.
I got Yake McGee coming up. No one in the pen.
Old B-hops at third. That was not a great throw to third base by Trout, though.
Yeah, we could add something there.
We could, yeah. Coulda, woulda, shoulda. What are you going to do?
We got Matt Kemp. Let's see what he does. We need to hit.
Mills, did your Patriots hang on?
My Patriots did hang on. I'm very close on Twitter right now, but there's some real fire going on in the Baltimore area Twitter. So I've decided not to celebrate.
Go Ravens. I need to do this.
For you MMA fans, there's a rumor going around right now that they're going to try to sign Nick Diaz versus Robbie Lawler for UFC 209. That would be amazing.
Oh!
Yeah.
Check, swing, cheddar cheese! Again.
I saw a really... Dana White did an interview with TSN up here when he was up here for you. This is just this past weekend, wasn't it? 206? Or is this
yes,
weekend?
Yes, 206 was this weekend, yeah.
Yeah, anyway, Dana got heated, talking about the union and talking about what's-his-face who missed weight.
Talking about that sports gamer getting dubs,
getting the walk offs. Wow, double walk off action tonight.
We out ya, as they say. Orlando again.
I don't know anybody who says that.
Hey man, I can't help that you're not cool in Canada. I'm kind of
a big deal. I just talk normal English. I try.
I'm a kind of a big deal in Canada. Little known fact.
I was glad that you noticed that I made an effort to spell favorite the American way on the submission form.
True. That was very impressive.
I tried.
All right. I'm pretty pumped here for multiple reasons. Congratulations, guys. We did great tonight. Got a couple dubs. Had a good chat about some bullpen banter. Miguel Sano, who I don't need, is the next award. And listen, you can tell this is not rigged. Because, hold on. Let me make sure he's following me. I'm pulling the winner for my Jeremy Shockey giveaway in Mutt. You'll be able to find out that answer in mere seconds.
It's me. And then I'm going to turn an immediate giveaway again. No, I'm kidding.
Well, let me tell you something. You got the first half right.
Woo!
Snaggle Jay somehow did win it.
Sweet.
Would you like to give it back to the community, or would you like to?
You know what? You can redraw for another winner.
Okay, please. Let me hit it random.
Please redraw. Whoa,
that's not
that. Yeah, I got it.
You got that for me, thanks, bud.
Yep. That ain't none of that up in here.
Clinton is the winner. Clinton Pasquale, assuming he actually retweeted it. He did. All right, guys. Great episode of Bullpen Banter tonight. Really had a lot of fun. Went a little longer than I was expecting. So not super long. It's before midnight? Amazing. Love it. Follow Chris on Twitter and all other places at SnaggleJ. Also, follow Chris on Twitter at MillenniumOS and Operation Sports on Twitch and the YouTubes. Oh, that's funny. He was the guy that tweeted me asking about the giveaway, and he won. Smallest of worlds. Chris's, do you have anything to add to this conversation?
Not me.
Other Chris's?
No, I'm good. I always love ending the stream with a good good walk off and a good ban in the chat. So yeah, it's a day well lived.
Yeah, we're definitely gonna get the not only the archive of Bullpen Banter up, but I will definitely separate out the phenomenal walk off that was a little bit too intense. I'm surprised I didn't get like a nosebleed or something, because that was pretty crazy. Thank you guys for joining me, chat. Thank you guys for also joining us. I appreciate that very much. You can tune into Bullpen Banter every Monday night at some time between 9 and 10 p.m. Eastern. We're still trying to lock that down. Some of us have babies that need to get to sleep and all sorts of other stuff they need to do post-baby goes to sleep. Like now I have to go put stuff in the dryer. Awesome. We're not living that life like Millennium where he can just do whatever he wants whenever he
wants. Damn right.
With whomever he wants.
I mean, jealous.
Are we jelly? Maybe.
A little bit.
Yeah. We're not about that life. No. We got a lockdown.
Keep in your pants.
So yeah. Thank you guys for joining me. Appreciate it. Chat again. Thank you guys for joining us. And get out of the bullpen. Get into the game. You know who didn't say that?
Buck Showalter.
Son of a bitch.